Ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday, the 24th day of February. The year is 2017, and if you can hear the sound of my voice, you are the revolution. I am revolutionary warrior number one, General Smokin' Joe McHale, and I would like to welcome you to day 166 of Operation Bring Down the Government. We are live from beautiful Sydney, Australia, and this is the Bring Down the Government live daily news, smashing through the lies of the Illuminati, smashing through the lies of the New World Order, and smashing through the lies of the government, who are escalating their attacks against humanity every single day. But even though they are escalating their attacks against us, my brothers and sisters, don't you dare be sour. Join Operation Bring Down the Government and feel the power. Yes, 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 I have the power. You have the power. We have the power. Humanity has the power. And we have to use that power, the power of love, to beat the Illuminati, to break the New World Order, and to bring down the government. Because we know that the only way for humanity to be free is for us to bring down the government that is enslaving us. Thank you all so much for joining me on this beautiful February afternoon. 20 revolutionary warriors already tuned in. Eric says, hello, sir. Thank you for tuning in, Eric. And who else here? Let me see. 21 revolutionary warriors already tuned in. Mario says, hello, Pharaoh of Egypt. Hello, Mario. Sherry, who is Revolutionary Warrior Free Spirit, Revolutionary Warrior number 433. And I sent your tags from the company in Canada today. Free Spirit, thank you for tuning in. And Shaka Zulu, who is Sleepy McCush, Revolutionary Warrior number 296. Thank you for tuning in. There is so much news to get to today, and I'm so glad that you are all here with me. Like I say every single day, resistance is victory. And Phil Polito, who is Revolutionary Warrior Dead Man 420, number 388. Thank you for tuning in, brother. And Eric says, I'm digging the beard. Thank you very much, Eric. And Compa Blanco 69, Revolutionary Warrior 171. Thank you for tuning in, bro. Zach, hello to you. And Angela says, love equals commitment and truth to humanity. We have to use the power of love to defeat these demons. And Brandon says, finally, Revolutionary Warrior 17 has come back to bring down the government. Keep up the good fight, brothers and sisters. One love together. They cannot stop us. Thank you very much, Half Pint and One Day. And Larry says, hey, Joe, how's it going? I'm great. How are you, my brother? And Free Spirit says, thanks, Joe. And Tracy said, don't inject the marijuana. Life lesson. I appreciate that, Tracy. You don't want to inject the marijuanas. Jared said, I blow that doty down. You should already know. I don't know what you're talking about. And Mama Spike, Revolutionary Warrior number 150. Thank you for tuning in, Mama Spike. The first article I'm going to read today, Police Chief, there are so many pedophiles, we can't jail them all. And we know these putrid, pestiferous, pusillanimous, pro-crustian pedophile networks go all the way through the government, and it's absolutely sickening what they do to these children. We have to do whatever we can to expose them. And Matthew says, I love the beard, keep up the good work. Thank you, brother, I'm never gonna stop. And Conrad says, g'day, mate. Hello, Conrad. And Compa Blanco 69 says, I'm back. Chef Smoking Joe, thank you for tuning in, brother. 28 revolutionary warriors already tuned in. And I'm very happy because we've almost hit 500 certified revolutionary warriors all over the world, from Sydney to Germany to Sweden to Iceland to the United States to Canada to New Zealand, all over the world. People are joining the Save the World Army. People are joining Operation Bring Down the Government, and I'm so happy about that. There are 494 revolutionary warriors all over the world. And right now, let's start the bidding on revolutionary warrior number 466. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. And Chatham says, yeah, you know me, revolutionary warrior number 135, Chatham D, my Gracie Baja brother. Thank you for tuning in from Texas. Andy says, smash out those truths while broadcasts can still go live. Excellent point. One people, harsh times, as armed Gestapo turf Native Americans from their lands at gunpoint, seeds of resistance being blown far and wide. Yes, we stand with everybody on the front lines, and I stand with all of you in the fight for our freedom. And Nino says, one love, salute. I salute all you revolutionary warriors. Mama Spike says, we need hard proof so media can't deny it. The proof is right in front of us. We can all see it. All it takes is the guts to do the research. Conrad says, brother, send me your address so I can send you a postcard. Send me a personal message. We'll see how we go. You send me a message, Conrad. And Dustin, yes, we are at 494 revolutionary warriors, almost hit 500. Dustin is revolutionary warrior number 378, Razor Blade. And Tabasco, who is revolutionary warrior number 5. Thank you very much for tuning in. She says, thanks, Joe. So very happy to join you tonight. I'm so glad to have you with us. I'm so glad to have you all with us. Like I say every single day, we are the ones who are on the front lines in this information war. And like someone else just said in the comments section, like Andy just said in the comments section, we don't know how much longer we're going to have the internet. They can switch off our Facebook accounts. I was banned the other day for 3 days. They can take away our internet access. They can switch off the electricity from the grid at the flick of a switch. We have to do whatever we can to expose their disgusting, decrepit, deleterious, demonic actions while we still have these tools at our fingertips. Thank you all so much for your support, and I'm sharing to a few groups right now as we speak. Tracy says, did you see Spicer call out the press today? Raise your hands. No, I did not see that, Tracy. Tasha, who's revolutionary warrior number 27, the Duchess, says 45 is killing it over here. What kind of alternate reality is this? And Ruben, who is revolutionary warrior number 14, F the police, he says, blaze it. I'm one ahead of you, my brother. And Razorblade asks, why did they block you? Because I'm doing this every single day. I'm sharing the truth. I am speaking the truth. And they don't want their disgusting pedophile networks to be exposed. They don't want the fact that they are poisoning and assaulting and raping and murdering people all over the world. They don't want that exposed. And I am the man to expose them. We are the men and women who are going to expose them. Thank you all for your support. And Shamanicus says, let's make it 501 tonight. Yes, right now we are bidding on revolutionary warrior number 466. If you'd like to be revolutionary warrior number 466, please put your bid in the comment section. We can start the bidding at $1. And F the police says, 562 Whittier representing Smokin' Joe. And he says, F Spicer. Much love to you, man. DJ Leslie, revolutionary warrior number 40, says, finally, DJ Leslie has come back live from Grafton, bringing down the government, breaking the Illuminati, and bringing down the New World Order. Tomorrow is my skydive. Woo! My brother Joe. And I told you this already, Les, if you're going to wear the tags on your skydive, make sure you tuck those into your shirt, my brother. Tracy asks, what do your medals hanging behind you represent? These are the medals that I won for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I won the gold medal in Gi at the Sydney Open, a gold medal in Gi and a gold medal in No-Gi at the Autumn Cup, a gold medal in Gi and a bronze medal in No-Gi at the Sydney Cup, and gold medal, the New South Wales champion in No-Gi Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. These are back when I was a white belt last year. I'm a blue belt now, looking forward to my first blue belt competition very soon. And somebody wants to make a stupid comment. You know what happens when you make stupid comments? You know what happens when you make asinine comments and try to distract my revolutionary warriors? You know what happens? You just made the list. Be gone, you mindless, moronic, mental midget. And Matthew says, beards for the revolution. I like the sound of that. And El Compa Blanco 69 says, you are the most impressing person I have known. That's very humbling. Thank you very much, brother. And Anthony says, get it out, brother. You! And F the Police says, warrior number 14. And Razor Blade says, we need to get the numbers up. And Purple Haze, revolutionary warrior number 411, checking in from the beautiful Gold Coast on this R&B Friday. Woo! And Tracy said, impressive, let's see those abs. Oh, we had to do it. Of course, I recommend a vegan diet, and I recommend a raw vegan diet, which I'm transitioning to. More definition than the dictionary. Can I get a woo? We have to be strong, we have to be healthy in order to defeat these demons. And Heavy J says, get him on the list. They're already on the list, my man. And Sleepy McCush said, your computer screen is really big. I just noticed in the mirror behind you, yeah, it's like a TV monitor, so I can read the articles while talking to you beautiful revolutionary warriors. We're at 46 simultaneous viewers right now. And when we hit 50, I'm going to give away a set of Bring Down the Government tags. So please hit that share button. And once again, we are bidding right now on Revolutionary Warrior number 466. If you'd like to bid on those, please put your bid in the comment section. We can start the bidding at $1. And F the Police says, that's what's up. And Mama Spike is cracking up. And Kelly says, good evening, sir. Good evening to you, Kelly. And Cynthia says, love you from Washington, USA. Much love to you, Cynthia. And Holly says, what do you think about that John Podesta interview? I'm not sure exactly which one you're talking about, Holly. And Nate, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 214. Flight Risk, thank you for tuning in, brother. And F the Police, no need to use bad language, my man. And Charmanicus says, Yahoo Natural News is gone. Time is short. Yeah, I saw how they're doing that. Jeff says, hello from Tennessee. Hello, my brother. And the Duchess says, Podesta the molester. How appropriate. And Charmanicus says, sorry, Google, not Yahoo. And Mama Spike says, I saw that, Darren. And Tracy says, John Podesta makes me want to vomit. He has a column now in the Washington Post announced today. J.R. Filthy, Revolutionary Warrior 316, says, it's sad they evicted one of the water protectors' camps today. That is true. And DJ Leslie says, can I get a woo? And Michelle and Jesse, Heavy J says, I'm going to drop $150 on your GoFundMe page. Bro, that's so kind of you. I really appreciate that. And I really appreciate the hard work being done by Revolutionary Warrior number 99, Warrior of God, and Revolutionary Sergeant number 419, Roxy Revolution. You know, right now I'm supposed to be in the United States, but the individual who was getting the flights for me didn't get the flights, so I didn't make it. But they started up a GoFundMe page, so I'm going to put the link right here. If you'd like to help the most electrifying man in dance music today. The two-time Guinness World Record breaker. The first ever human being to DJ for 7 days straight. The most revolutionary man in the world today, Smoking Joe McHale. To get to the United States, please hit up this GoFundMe page, and I really appreciate that, and I appreciate everybody's hard work. I will get to the United States one day with your help. And Compa Blanco 69 says, I'm a share it. And Purple Haze says, everybody hear the latest. We need 10 serves of fruit and veg a day, not three. I'm doing my best. I bought another nice tray of mangoes today. And Razorblade says, so what's the plan? We must have a plan. Our plan is twofold, to organize ourselves and to expose all of the government's crimes. Furthermore, we have to play off the enemy. To quote Sun Tzu, one of the most important quotes because it's on the back of the book. Water shapes its course according to the nature of the ground over which it flows. The soldier works out his victory in relation to the foe whom he is facing. Therefore, just as water retains no constant shape, so in warfare there are no constant conditions. And of course, that's a quote from The Art of War. And the Duchess says, how do you eat 10 servings? I can only eat once a day. A really big smoothie or a juice will help a lot. And Pema Gedun, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 443. Pema Gedun, thank you very much for tuning in. I just got that now. Pema Gedun, thank you very much for tuning in. She says, remember, justice wins wars without a sword, but with a pen, and mercy is the pen, and the nations tremble at her feet. Beautiful quote. And Tracy says, any thoughts on the radiation iodine they found over there in Europe? I saw that headline. I didn't read the article. It is crazy. So much radiation, not only from Fukushima, from these devices, from everywhere, is seeping into our world. Not only radiation, but heavy metals as well. They are doing their best to stupefy humanity, and we have to stand up against them on all fronts. Shamanicist says, Leslie, sorry about the Fandango vid I sent. Don't let it put you off the jump. Just check your parachute is not a bag of washing. And Majed says, good morning. Sweet, lovely day. Yes. Oh, what a wonderful afternoon. Oh, what a beautiful day. Thank you for tuning in, Majed. And Razorblade says, where in the States were you visiting? New Orleans. Yes, I was planning to visit all 50 United States. And that will happen once again. And Revolutionary Warrior number 60, Kentucky Warrior, says, Susan has come through her surgery fine. That's awesome. She had to have 23 titanium screws and rods and pins, 13 on each side. Thank you all for the prayers and best wishes. Our love will save the world. Yes, it will. And I'm so glad to hear that Revolutionary Warrior number 155, Southern Beauty, came out of her operation. All good, man. Send her my love. Much love to both of you guys. Thank you very much. And Compa Blanco 69 says, you're a strong warrior. So are all of you. Holly says, there's a new John Podesta interview. You should check it out. He doesn't deny the emails. Just say the Russians hacked it. It's pathetic. I will check that out. Thank you, Holly. And Razorblade says, you need to come to New Orleans. I do. And Tracy says, how do we expose the government? By doing exactly what we're doing right here, right now. By talking about all of their crimes, by exposing what they are doing, how they are killing people, how they are poisoning people, how they are raping people, how they are enslaving the human race. That's how we expose them. Right here, right now, right here, right now. And yes, Razorblade, that is the art of war. And the Duchess says, 10 servings of smoothie, I think I'd die. No, you get a whole bunch of servings, like maybe more than half a dozen in one smoothie. That's what I'm saying. And you won't die. You'll live longer. You'll be healthier. That's the whole point. And Kentucky Warrior, Revolutionary Sergeant number 60, thank you for tuning in, bro. And Heavy J says, we love you, Smokin' Joe. We will bring down the government. United we stand. We won't fall. Exactly right, my brother. Together we will defeat them. And Free Spirit says, no, Tasha, 10 servings of the one smoothie. Yes, exactly. Razorblade says, the powerful really believe it's easier to kill us than to control us. They're doing their best to kill us very slowly and also very fast in other areas of the world. Of course, all of the wars all over the world, all of the police killing people. It's a multi-pronged attack from a myriad of angles. That's why we have to keep fighting back with everything that we have. And Patty Zambrano who is revolutionary warrior number 461, resists the power. Thank you for tuning in. TJ says, tuning in, brother. Love the work. Keep it up. I'll be seeing you soon. Nice one, TJ, my brother. And the Duchess says, ha. And Fox42 says, the Art of War audiobook. She posted the YouTube link. Thank you very much for that, Fox42. And Cynthia said, Paul Ryan just said poor kids who ate free lunch are soulless. US Speaker of the House. We know that all of these scumbags worship Satan. We know who the real soulless ones are. We know who sold their souls long ago. And we will defeat them, my brothers and sisters. All right, I'm going to share to a couple of groups here before I get started reading today's news. And right now we are bidding on revolutionary warrior number 466. If you would like to bid on those, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1 if you would like to get your hands on this set of Bring Down the Government tags. And Resist the Power says, you crack me up when you say my name. You mean Patty Zambrano. I do enjoy saying that. I must admit, sharing to Anonymous Australia right now. And Rapicon, who is revolutionary warrior number 201, says, hello, warriors. Much love to you all. Much love to you. Cynthia says, US is trying to depopulate and they aren't hiding it anymore. You're exactly right. The poison in the water, the poison in the air, the poison in the food, the poison in the medicine, the radiation everywhere around us. It is truly evil what they are doing. We must stand up against them. And Tracy says, I feel like this world is a messed up reality show right now. All the liars are coming out. The people are rising. I'll tell you what, this is no TV show. This is no movie. This is no video game, my brothers and sisters. This is your life, and it's ending 1 second at a time. The question is, what are you going to do to stand up for the free people all around the world, the innocent people all around the world who are being enslaved by this evil machine that call themselves the government? I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do my absolute best to expose them and organize the people who stand against them, and I know we will be victorious. Shall we succeed? Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. 100% guaranteed. Guaranteed. And Duchess says, good thing no one cares what Paul Ryan thinks. Yes. And Tracy said, do you mind if I share you to a couple groups? Please, not only do I not mind, I encourage it. Thank you all so much for sharing this video. Please share it wherever you can. Share it on your personal page. Share it on your friends' pages. Tag your friends in the comments section. Share it in any groups that you're a member of. Of course, share it in anti-New World Order groups. Share it to anti-chemtrail groups. Share it to anti-vaccine groups. Share it to anti-GMO groups. Share it to anti-police state groups. Share it to anti-police brutality groups. Share it anywhere that you can. And on top of that, please share it to any groups that you're a member of that have nothing to do with the fight for freedom. Share them to dog groups, share them to cat groups, share them to football groups, share them to nightclub groups, share them to coffee groups, share them to buy, sell, swap groups. My brothers and sisters, the time is short. And once again, we don't know how much longer we're going to have the internet as a tool to wake people up. They can turn it off at the flick of a switch. So thank you all so much for taking the time and having the courage to look past all of the ridicule and all of the mockery and all of the mindless, moronic, mental midgets who are going to make fun of us for speaking the truth. Thank you all for having the courage to share this video. Thank you all for your support. And I'm sharing to a few more groups here, sharing to Anonymous now. And Shamanica says, remember, people giving feels amazing. Yes. And Free Spirit says, we now live in a nation where... And Cynthia has the high bid right now with $1 for revolutionary warrior number 466. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comment section. Cynthia has the high bid with $1. Thank you. Pemageddon says, I think you breathe deep and circulate breath to go 7 days. OMG, I can do yoga for 8 hours straight just because it's sleeping time and have to then go to work and afterwards take care of the family until work again. But 7 days is a Guinness Book winner. Cheers, mate. Thank you, Pemageddon. I have started doing yoga about a year ago. They do yoga on Tuesday nights at my jiu-jitsu school, and I love it. And Pemageddon says, I do think Fukushima is the most important issue. There are so many important issues that we have to get through. And Compablanco69 says, what do you think about what Trump is doing to Muslims and marijuana? Of course, he is the divisive candidate. He is New World Order Illuminati to the core. He was trained at a Jesuit university. He is one of them. I'm going to talk about what he's doing with marijuana soon, but he is further bringing about the clash of civilizations by continuing to bomb all of these Muslim countries and by continuing to fund ISIS through the CIA and through all of these US groups. It is absolutely evil what they are doing. And once again, I'm going to talk about what he said about marijuana, how Trump wants to make a crackdown on recreational weed smoking. Yeah, you heard it. And Charmanica says the world needs to disown their mainstream identity. And Pemageddon says, I agree that Fukushima needs to be talked about. And Sherry said, oops, sorry, where doctors destroy health, lawyers destroy justice, universities destroy knowledge, governments destroy freedom, the press destroys information, religion destroys morals, and our banks destroy the economy. That's a great quote. Tracy said, our Disney Prime Minister Trudeau is a joke right now. They are all a pathetic joke. Warrior of God 99, thank you very much for tuning in, and thank you so much for setting up that GoFundMe page to get me to the United States and for your donation. Much love to you. I will get there. And Cynthia says, please tell us where to send funds for smoke and joe in the USA. Thank you, I will help. Thank you so much. I'll post that link in the comments section right here, right now. Thank you all so much for your support. I will get there. And Mama Spike says, this politically correct world has lost their mind. A college, I think in Michigan, banned whiteboards, said they were racist. And yeah, somewhere else they banned brown bags because they said they were racist. Absolutely asinine how they are destroying language. And like Orwell said, I'm paraphrasing here, when you control language, you control the people. And Razorblade says, the truth warriors that are in the military will have a heavy responsibility. Yes, they should all quit their stinking government jobs. And Free Spirit says, hi, Lisa. And Chemtrails UK, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 324, thank you for tuning in, bro. He says, g'day to all. And Warrior of God says, hi, Free Spirit. And Pemageddon says, the only way we come out of it alive is being able to be more and more non-physical, super energy brothers and sisters. It's very possible. Go yoga, be metaphysical, and be alive. Fantastic points, Pemageddon. And Gord, who is Revolutionary Warrior 181, Gordian Knot, thank you for tuning in, my brother. And Jens says, hello from Europe. Stay strong and stay together. Thank you for tuning in, my European brother. And Sleepy McCush says, have you ever caught someone in a standing triangle choke and made them tap or pass out? No, definitely not. I haven't really learned the flying triangle. That's the only way you can really do it when you're standing. But I do love the triangle choke, and I have made a bunch of people tap to that. I do love that. But I like the move that I call the bring down the government more, which is an armless triangle choke. Anyway, more on that later. And Compa Blanco 69 said Donald Trump is trash in the comment section. Tracy Parker said marijuana is a plant. They want to control our food, plants and seeds. Yes, they want to control the whole food supply with Codex Alimentarius. And Pamageddon says, yes, Free Spirit, good quote. And Nino says, do you know who is Daryl Anka or Basha, Esther Hicks or Abraham? They're channeling some good spirits or entity who lives in some other dimension. I love them and their philosophy. See them on YouTube and listen if you want. Very, very positive vibes, smart talking. Yeah, I'll tell you what, I don't know. I'm not going to be channeling any entities anytime soon, because when you try and channel some kind of entity, you open the door for other evil, demonic entities to make their way into your life. I don't want none of that. Thank you very much. And bear with me while I just clear my throat and have a drink of water. 46 revolutionary warriors tuned in. 48. I'll give away a set of Bring Down the Government tags when we hit 50. Thank you very much for sharing. Oh yeah. And Warrior of God says easily, and God says yes. And Laurie Ann, who is revolutionary warrior number 133, truth will win. Thank you for tuning in. She says, greetings, brothers and sisters. Thank you very much for joining us. And resist the power says, it's no longer a matter of countries. We are global or on the same plane and connecting through forms like this or forums like this. We are awake and we will be victorious. And Sin City Jason, revolutionary warrior number 40, thank you for tuning in from Viva Las Vegas. And Razorblade says, no, no, man, these guys are going to be the good within and they won't turn on us when they will be ordered. Brother, let me tell you right now, if you follow orders from an evil organization, you are not a good man. You are not a good woman. It's as simple as that. When you follow orders, you are abdicating your mental responsibility and you do what someone tells you to do. That is the definition of evil. And TJ says, phone died. I'm back, brother. Love the work. Words can't express how proud to be a part of it. Thank you very much, my brother, TJ. Timothy says, what is this page about? It's about bringing down the government, because governments all over the world are poisoning the air, the water, the food. They are raping, assaulting, murdering, enslaving innocent people. It's up to us to bring them down. Josh says, got some good pictures of some chemtrails over Queensland, slowly getting proof. The proof is so voluminous. Thank you so much for documenting that, Josh. Free Spirit says, everything is energy. Your thoughts begin it, your emotions amplify it, and your actions increase its momentum, getting stronger every day. Warriors, you had better believe it. And Compa Blanco 69 said, Obama said it all in this video, and he posted the link. Sin City Jason said, lots of wind yesterday, and pollen is super high. I'm feeling like crap tonight, about to have a gigantic bowl of tofu, hot and sour soup to clear my head. Nice one, enjoy that. Bon appetit, Sin City Jason. And Pemageddon says, dang, chemtrails are really killing art, especially since they spread the flu for money, and etc, etc. Codex Alimentarius is worthwhile looking into, for you especially, Joe. It's implemented in Australia already. Yes, I was just speaking about Codex Alimentarius a moment ago. And Warrior of God shared. Thank you very much. And Nino says, yes, I understand, but just listen what they are talking about. And Timothy says, this account's name is misleading. Really? We're here to bring down the government, my man. What you gonna do about it? Account's name is misleading. Shamanica said, yes, Tracy, they want us to submit and be zombies. I will never, ever submit. And Truth Will Win says, we're about sharing and spreading truth and knowledge. You hit the nail right on the head. Truth Will Win. And Pemageddon posted a YouTube link, and Free Spirit says, name means nothing, actions mean everything. What did Shakespeare say? What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. I still remember a bit of Shakespeare. And Warrior of God says, you betray yourself when you do not think for yourself. Exactly. When you follow orders, you betray yourself, and you're selling your soul, man. 45 revolutionary warriors tuned in. We got up to 49. We're on 47 now. When we hit 50, I'll give away a set of Bring Down the Government tags. We have 494 revolutionary warriors already all over the world. And thank you so much for sharing this video. Thank you all so much for being part of the Save the World Army and for being part of Operation Bring Down the Government. We will beat the Illuminati. We will break the New World Order and we will bring down the government. My brothers and sisters, we are the ones who are setting humanity free. And Pemageddon said, so it's all about culling population. That's exactly what it's about. and we are the ones who have to stop them. I'll tell you what, there are more of us than there are of them, and they can't handle the fact that we are spreading the truth. It's so difficult for them because they have to lay out all of these lies every single day to keep the average lounge locked, lobotomized lab rat in line. But we see straight through their lies, and it's easy for us because we have the truth on our side. And although it's tough to wake people up, we don't have to keep hammering on the people who don't want to wake up and who are never going to wake up. We have to organize amongst ourselves and really work hard to expose what is going on. That is how we will defeat this demonic government. Thank you all so much for your support. And Marcus, who is revolutionary warrior number 445, Shaka Green Room. Thank you for tuning in, my brother. He says, sup, dude, keep the fight going, my brother. Man, I won't stop because I can't stop. Josh says, once everyone accepts and knows the evil acts the governments around the world are doing, the government will fall. Yes, they will crumble, my brother. And Dustin said, so what's everyone here do for a living? Yo, Dustin, let's not just fill up the comment section with chit-chat. It takes me a lot of energy to read every single comment at a million miles an hour anyway, so let's keep the comments pertinent, please. And Flight Risk said, every gun that is made, every warship launched, every rocket fired signifies in the final sense a theft from those who hunger and are not fed, those who are cold and are not clothed. This world in arms is not spending money alone. It is spending the sweat of its laborers, the genius of its scientists, the hopes of its children. This is not a way of life at all in any true sense. Under the clouds of war, it is humanity hanging on a cross of iron. Very relevant quote all those years later from President Dwight D. Eisenhower. Nino says they also talk how to change the world in a peaceful way with only good energy and vibes. Timothy says, what countries, for example, would you say have a corrupt government? Every single one. Every single one. Every single one. And we just hit 52 simultaneous viewers. Thank you all so much. So right now I'm going to give away a set of Bring Down the Government tags. We can give away 467. So, once again, if you already have a set of tags, please don't enter this particular giveaway. We want to have more new revolutionary warriors, as well as people building up their squads. But if you already have a set of tags, please don't enter this particular contest. If you want to win a set of tags, message this Bring Down the Government Facebook account saying, we will be victorious. Don't write that in the comments section. Don't write it on Joe McHale's wall or any wall or anything like that. Write it in a message to this Bring Down the Government Facebook inbox. The first individual to do that will win a set of Bring Down the Government tags. And let me go back to your comments here. Cynthia says, not lies, alternate facts, USA. And Shaka Zulu says, Shaka. And Resist the Power says, all governments to an extent. Yes. T.H. Hall, revolutionary warrior number 37 says, as soon as you say something important, the video stream stops. And Mama Spike says, Timothy, all of them. And Duchess says, I'm a rocket surgeon. And Pema posted a link from Dr. Rima Libo about Codex Alimentarius. Thank you very much for that, Pemageddon. And yes, we've hit 50 viewers. And Cynthia says, Cindy needs tags. And Joshua Page Amos, who is revolutionary warrior number 441. Thank you for tuning in, Joshua. And let me see right now who won this set of tags. Thank you all so much for your support. Still 53 revolutionary warriors tuned in as we speak. And I'm going to share this video to a few more groups right now. All right, who won this set of tags? I'm going to share to some Aussie groups as well. And thank you all. I can see in the on this tablet here that a bunch of you are sharing this video. Thank you all so much for your support. All right, we have a winner. All right, the winner of Revolutionary Warrior number 467 is Sophie Stephanie Rolfson. Congratulations to you, Sophie Stephanie Rolfson. You are now Revolutionary Warrior number 467. Please send me a message. Let me know what you would like as your Bring Down the Government code name, 15 characters or less. Congratulations to you, Sophie. And Chandler, TJ, Peter, you guys were close. And when we hit 100 simultaneous viewers, I'll give away another set of Bring Down the Government tags. From memory, I think we got over 100 yesterday as well. So thank you all for your support. And right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 366. And Cynthia has the high bid with $1. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comment section. Once again, the high bid is $1. And Shaka Green Room says, P.S. Don't ever shave that glorious beard, Joe. I'm not going to shave it anytime soon. It's good for choke defense in jiu-jitsu. Flight Risk says, good luck all. Welcome to our future. And Sleepy McCush says, I keep losing the stream. Stay with us, brother. Sophie says, woot woot, 467. I'm so honored. Thank you very much, Sophie. Glad to have you aboard. Once again, let me know what you'd like your code name to be. And TJ has the high bid now on Revolutionary Warrior number 466 with $5. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comments section. Charmanicus says, and we will be victorious, just to be clear. Yes. And Free Spirit says, nice, Sophie. And Warrior God says, woo. And Cynthia, once again, now has the high bid on number 466 with $10. And TJ just came in with $15. So thank you very much. TJ has the high bid with $15 for Revolutionary Warrior number 466. If you'd like to bid on those, please put your bid in the comments section. The first article for today from yournewswire.com. Police chief, there are so many pedophiles, we can't jail them all. Really? Really? And Compa Blanco 69 says, woo! And Sleepy McCush says, woo! February 23, 2017 by Baxter Dimitri. There are so many active pedophiles at large that if they were all convicted and sent to jail, the prison system would not be able to hold them all, according to a police chief. Chief Superintendent Gavin Thomas warns the sex offenders register is growing so quickly that police simply do not have the ability or the desire to monitor pedophiles as hoped. The dire warnings come after it was revealed that the police chief investigating claims the former British Prime Minister Ted Heath was a prolific pedophile is convinced they are 120% genuine. The Daily Mail reports more than 30 people have come forward with claims of sexual abuse by the former Conservative Prime Minister, according to well-placed sources. And they are said to have given strikingly similar accounts of incidents to Wiltshire Police, even though the individuals are not known to each other. The Mail on Sunday has been told that Wiltshire Chief Constable Mike Veal regards the allegations as totally convincing and plans to publish a report in June. Detectives have established that, contrary to claims that Sir Edward could not have committed the crimes as he never drove a car and always had a police driver with him, he did drive and he did have a car. They have photographic evidence that shows he is a driver and have established that he had a driving license. He also bought a Rover 2000 after being deposed as Tory leader by Margaret Thatcher in 1975 when he was 58. Going back to your comments here. So sickening, these pedophiles. Joshua Amos says, "How are you, brother? I'm good, man. It just makes me so angry what they are doing to these children." Cynthia has the high bid with $20. TJ says, "I'm out, brother. Got to go back to work. Let me know how the bidding goes. Peace out. We will be victorious." And Free Spirit says, "How about castrating them instead? As much as we might have the urge to hurt people who are hurting children, we can't ever use violence. We can't live in a spirit of revenge. We can't live in a spirit of violence. He who digs a hole for his brother is going to fall in." That's paraphrasing what my dad said. We can't use violence. We have to use peaceful means to expose them and bring them down. They have all the guns. If we use violence, they will turn it back against us. They will escalate the violence exponentially. And I'm not here to muck around. I'm not here to play games. I'm here to win the fight for freedom. I'm here to succeed in Operation Bring Down the Government. And I don't want any of you to get hurt. We cannot ever use violence. And TJ says, "I'm out, brother. Got to go back to work. Let me know how the bidding goes. Peace out. We'll be victorious." I already read that. And TJ comes back with $25. TJ has the high bid with $25 now. And Razorblade says, "Well, maybe do something else with them. Perhaps hung. Once again, we cannot use violence." Wayne says, "Code name Rollin' Roller." Awesome, Wayne. I've been trying to get in touch with you about your code name. Waiting on my tags, brother. I was waiting on your code name. And he said, "Oh, it's true. What about the Pope then? Pope is another one of these putrid, pestiferous, pusillanimous, procrustean pedophiles. It makes me truly sick. We have to bring all of them down. We have to expose all of them." And I'll put you in the spreadsheet right now, Wayne. Congratulations. You are now revolutionary warrior number 386, Rollin' Roller. I like that name. Thank you, brother. And Cynthia says, "TJ, you liar, $30. And someone wants to tell me to put a shirt on. Brother, I got more definition than the dictionary. You wish you were as shredded as Smokin' Joe McHale. You know what happens when you tell the most revolutionary man in the world today to put a shirt on? You know what happens? You just made the list. Be gone. Be gone, you idiotic troll. Where is he? Ain't nobody got time for trolls. See you later." So Cynthia has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 466 with $30. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comment section. This auction will end in 5 minutes. And TJ says, "Ha, Cynthia, you win today. I won't be able to bid anymore. Good luck, guys. Love you all. Much love to you, TJ. Thank you very much." Lachlan says, "Results for essay I sent you. Come back today." Woo! Lachlan, my brother, I haven't even read that essay yet. Can you please send it to me again? Sorry, man. I have just so much stuff that people send me and so much that I have to read and research. Lachlan, Revolutionary Warrior number 321, Speaky, please send me that essay again, bro. And what were the results? You're saying, woo! So I'm guessing you got some kind of good mark for that, bro. And guys, let's not waste our time replying to these trolls, please, because I'm reading through these comments and I don't want to have to skip your comments. And everyone says, "Thank you, TJ." Compa Blanco says, "Much love, brother TJ." Chris Bird, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 423, Admiral of Truth. I salute you, Admiral. He says, "We can change the world. Share this with your friends." Yes. But I don't agree, once again, with that middle emoticon that you put, because that is the Mark of the Beast sign. And Warrior of God says 86th. And Duchess says, "Don't violate the nap." And Scott says, "Amen, brother." And Wayne says, "We cannot fight hate with hate." Yes. And Warrior of God says, "I love Grizzly Adams, a real man." Compa Blanco says, "It keeps lagging." And Warrior of God says, "Women adore real, honest men. Well, you're looking at one right here. And Orlando says, bring him down. That's what we're doing. Tabasco says, it makes me so angry that people are so blind that they refuse to even acknowledge the satanic, child-killing, molesting truth. It's horrible. It's beyond me how nobody cares. Totally inhuman. Yes, we care, and we are going to expose them. We're going to bring them down. And TJ Buckley says, you did not just use a Chris Jericho quote. You're the man. Yes, I have to quote the Ayatollah of rock and roller on that one. And Warrior of God says he is a putrid pontiff. And Jason says, what's up? What's up, my brother? Thank you for tuning in. And Truth Will Win says, we should give them all multiple life sentences, lock them all up in prison together, and set up cameras everywhere with a live stream so we as citizens can log in anytime and watch them destroy each other. That is definitely not something I would want to tune into. And look, I don't want to put anyone in jail. I don't want to hurt anyone. I just want to stop this system of satanic slavery and pedophilia. I just want to bring them down. I don't want to organize trials. I don't want to make courts. I don't want to have judges. Judge not, lest ye be judged. I just want to bring down this system and stop them from doing what they're doing. And Reefer Revolution, Revolutionary Warrior number 114, thank you for tuning in. He says, good afternoon, Joe. Hope you're well. Brother, I'm better than good and better than most. And Compa Blanco 69 says, we will be victorious. And Warrior of God is cracking up. I'm not sure what you're laughing at, Warrior of God. And Tabasco said, ain't nobody got time for that. Keep it moving, Joe. Blaze it. Jason, living the dream, brother. How are you? And Joshua Amos says, I'm going ahead to bed now. Just wanted to stop by. I'll see you, brother. Much love, Joshua. And I ordered your tags today. They're coming straight to you from Canada. You should get those very soon. And Mohi said 9/11 was an inside job, like if you agree, from the top to the bottom, from the left to the right, from inside out, 100% a false flag attack. Pemageddon says, I've been awake for more than 7 days straight doing yoga and just daily routines. Don't accuse me of doing drugs. That's a lol lol. I did no drugs, no coffee, no energy drinks when I broke the Guinness World Record for the longest DJ set in history. And yeah, who needs drugs? And Chemtrails UK is back. Thank you for tuning in once again. 2 minutes to go. In fact, 1 minute and 15 seconds to go in the auction for Revolutionary Warrior number 466. And who had the high bid? Cynthia has the high bid with $30. So if you'd like to bid on that, there are 60 seconds to go. Thank you very much for your support. Astonishingly, Mr. Vale is also understood to support claims that Sir Edward's alleged crimes were reported to police years ago but covered up by the establishment. Some of those who said Sir Edward, I'm not going to call this guy Sir Edward anymore, this scumbag pedophile, Edward abused them, are believed to have told police they went on to commit sexual abuse crimes themselves as a result. The investigation into scumbag Edward, I'm going to call him scumbag Edward now, called Operation Conifer, was set up in 2015 in the wake of the Jimmy Savile scandal. Mr. Veal came under pressure to abandon the inquiry last year after separate claims of a pedophile ring at Westminster involving former Home Secretary, the late Lord Britain, scumbag Britain, and former Defence Chief, scumbag Bramall, were found to be groundless. Allegations that scumbag Edward was involved in satanic orgies have been dismissed as a fantasy by an expert asked to review the case. Doubtless, this expert is a satanic sycophant as well. However, the Mail on Sunday has been told that Mr. Vale believes the pedophile allegations are genuine. A source said Mr. Vale believes in them 120% and thinks they are totally convincing. There are very close similarities in the accounts given by those who have come forward. The same names used for him, the same places, and same type of incidents keep coming up. What stands out is the people giving these accounts are not connected, but the stories and the details dovetail. It contains disturbing stuff. Investigators have been shocked by what they have learned. Incredibly evil, incredibly disgusting. We must bring these demons down. Charmanicus says, men adore real, honest women. Me too. But you know what they say, A good heart these days is hard to find, so please be gentle with this heart of mine. Pemageddon says, I never doubted ya for a second, my brother. Kriya, shout out. Much love to you, Pemageddon. And Orlando says, the population control is a lie. They don't have to poison us slowly with chemtrails and such to keep the world with limited population. All freaking lies. Bring them down. We are here to bring them down. And it looks like we have a winner. Congratulations to Cynthia Franzen. You are now Revolutionary Warrior number 466. Congratulations to you, Cynthia. Welcome to the Save the World Army. Welcome to Operation Bring Down the Government. And let me put you in here. Thank you very much for all of your support. You are now Revolutionary Warrior number 400 and... Oh, I've got the numlock on. 466, Cynthia. And now let's start the bidding for Revolutionary Warrior number 468. 468. If you'd like to be Revolutionary Warrior number 468, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. And Roland Roller says, we just had two young girls in Indiana murdered at a park. She managed to record his voice. Down the hill was what was recorded. Eerie voice, the voice of the devil. Pedophiles are silent and deadly, but goodwill will always prevail. Keep up the great work, brother. Thank you, my bro. I'm never going to stop in my quest to defeat these demons, and we will be victorious. And the Admiral of Truth says, welcome, Cynthia. And Free Spirit says, I read that article, Wayne. Heartbreaking. It's so evil what they're doing. And Tiffany Tisdale, thank you very much for tuning in. Back to this article. Another source said the police were initially skeptical about the allegations, but now believe them. And they have come round to the view that they were covered up in the past because of who Heath was. They will not be deflected by the rich and powerful trying to do the same now. Mike Vale is doing a great job and should be congratulated for his courage. And I salute him and everybody who is exposing these putrid pedophiles. The disclosures come after several senior politicians dismissed the allegations against Heath as absurd and unfounded. Former Tory Foreign Secretary scumbag Malcolm Rifkin complained Heath's reputation was being besmirched. What are they, King William Regal, besmirching their reputation? These evil demons. Heath's sexuality has been the source of much speculation over the years. Some believe he was gay. Others said he was asexual. Yeah, he was a sexual predator. At one point, he was being investigated by no fewer than 5 police forces, the Met, Wiltshire, Hampshire, Kent, and Jersey. The claims, some of which have been proved false, include alleged links to a convicted brothel keeper known as Madam Ling Ling, a pedophile dossier compiled by Labour peer Baroness Castle. This is what they call themselves, Baroness. I can think of something else to call her starting with a B, but this is a family show. Said he offered young boys trips on his yacht, and in a separate incident, one man claimed scumbag Edward picked him up hitchhiking in Kent as a 12-year-old in the 1960s and lured him to his Mayfair flat. Labour MP Tom Watson also said he had received allegations about scumbag Edward. However, the claims Mr. Vale is investigating, which date from the 1960s to 1990s, are not linked to the discredited evidence of the man known as Nick, who alleged a high-level pedophile ring. And Admiral of Truth says, are we going to hit 500 tonight? Yeah, you'd better believe we will. And Resist the Power, I think your name is Resist the Power. Let me confirm. Yes, Resist the Power says, the pedophile situation has been around for a long time and has transgressed throughout history. So let's concentrate on how we make a dent in that industry. Once again, by exposing them. Once again, by shedding light on their dark deeds. Cynthia says, did I just win? Sound went out. Yes, congratulations, Cynthia. You are now Revolutionary Warrior number 466. Send me a message, please let me know, or in the comment section, what you'd like your code name to be. And right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comment section. We can start the bidding at $1. And Chemtrails UK says, gotta go, bro, it's late in the UK, 4:49 a.m. Up at 8 a.m., see you soon. Get some sleep, my brother, Chemtrails UK. Have a good night. And Free Spirit says, yes, congrats. And Shaka Zulu says, William Regal, the wrestler, yes. And Compa Blanco 69 says, the major key to being successful, you have to keep your head above the water. DJ Khaled. I don't know about DJ Khaled, but Napoleon Hill said that self-discipline is the master key to success. And Razorblade says, peace to all of you and Joe. Have to get some shut-eye. Much love to you, Razorblade. And Warrior of God says, a panda, lol, Madam Ling Ling. And Cynthia says, sorry, I will pick it up after done streaming. Block out for now. Cynthia 466 will message your Facebook page about the tags. Yeah, I hate it when they block me. All good. You are the winner, Cynthia. And if you would like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. And Warrior of God said, sorry, this is so sad. I have to laugh in order to succeed. Yeah, I know what you mean. And Free Spirit says, the justice system is a joke. I pressed charges on my stepfather last year with over 15 historical statements from people who knew 30-odd years ago. I can't take it any further as there's not enough evidence. Yeah, because most of these judges are pedophiles as well. What a joke. Makes me so mad on a very personal level. They must be stopped, and we are here to stop them. And Warrior of God says, woo, 466. And she says, 468 is up now. And Roland Roller says, got to work in the morning. Peace to all my warrior brothers. Much love to you, Roland Roller. And Zoltan says, ooga booga. Any more stupid comments, Zoltan, you're going to get booted off this page. One of the key counterclaims made when the allegations first surfaced came from former Cabinet Secretary Lord Armstrong, who worked with Heath when he was Prime Minister. He said Heath never drove a car and always had at least one policeman with him from 1970 until his death in 2005. Yeah, likely story. The fact that scumbag Edward could drive was confirmed last night by a friend who said the former Prime Minister bought a car in 1975, although scumbag Edward was later given a chauffeur, driven car and police guard after IRA death threats. So sickening what they're doing. And here's something else that's sickening. Amish farmer facing 68 years in federal prison for making homemade products. February 23, 2017 by Vicky Batts. And I'll put the link to this in the comments section. And Cynthia says, I'm staying right here even if they block me. Hope it still counts because I won't back down to the man. Thank you for staying with us, Cynthia. You know what? I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground. Won't be turned around. And I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground. And I won't back down. Never am I gonna back down. Never, ever, ever. And Resist the Power says, we could go on and on about pedophiles, but actions have to start. So how to expose them? Do we protest peacefully at their home, at work? I'm from America. There is freedom of speech and there is freedom of speech. Be prepared to go to jail. I am and will stand tall. Already I'm 5'11". I can grow taller and stronger. We have to use whatever means we can, Patty. Protest on the streets. Protest online. Wake as many people up as possible. When they see how government officials are raping these children, they will come over to our side. Shamanica says, I will rephrase, these pedos literally need a taste of their own medicine. chemical castration courtesy of Big Pharma. And Warrior of God says, love. Majed says, cool. Compa Blanco 69 says, I'll be back. Gonna get a cup of water. And Free Spirit says, fluoride free, I hope. And Adam, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 240, cannabis cures. Thank you for tuning in. Zoltan says, good English for dark skinned man, really? Well, I think. No, I won't ban you yet, Zoltan. Amy said, Mary said, I'll give you $1,000 if you tell Pemageddon to get some sleep. I think she'll be fine. She probably knows when she needs to get some sleep. And Cannabis Cure says, so whom is the trolls wanting to fight? Ah, these idiots couldn't fight their way out of a wet paper bag, my brother. And Cynthia says, now there is a message broadcast interrupted. Man, they are scared of you, Smoking Joe. They'd better be scared because we are bringing these putrid pedophiles down. And Warrior of God said, my feed has been perfect. Right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these tags, please put your bid in the comment section. We can start the bidding at $1. Amish farmer facing 68 years in federal prison for making homemade products. When most people imagine their golden years, they don't envision spending the last decades of their life in a federal prison. But for 56-year-old Samuel Girod, that threat is very real. Thanks to the FDA. Girod is facing 68 years in jail for the simple crime of creating his own all-natural homemade products. Father to 12 and grandfather to 25, Girod has been facing a 12-count indictment since 2015. Trouble first arose for the Amish farmer back in 2013 when someone reported his homemade products to the State Health Department of Missouri. An injunction was put in place by a federal judge in the state banning Girod from making some of his products until specific conditions were met. One of these conditions was an inspection of the property where Girod's products were made, prompting the state of Kentucky to become involved. Production of these homemade natural products reportedly took place at Girod's family home somewhere along Satterfield Lane in Bath County. Bath County residents were seemingly appalled when they learned of their neighbor's fate. I can't even figure out what he has done wrong. They live at the foot of the cross, and the thought of one of them intentionally doing something wrong is outrageous, Sousa Moody, a fellow Bath County resident, commented. Family friend Sally O said, they are just devastated. I mean, when they brought him out in handcuffs, it was awful. O went on to say that the FDA had taken issue with the way some of Girod's products were labeled. Girod's chickweed salve was a particular point of contention. According to O, the salve's ingredients included rosemary, beeswax, and olive oil. It said chickweed salve up top, then on down said cures cancer, which for some people it did, but he can't say that. Oh no, they are putting a limit on your language. So he changed it to say healing chickweed, but they said no, you can't say healing. No, they own that word. They own nothing. So now it just says original chickweed, she explained. Moody questioned whether or not the proposed punishment really fit the crime. I mean, do you go to jail because you've messed up a label on a product? I thought you went to jail because you did something bad. I mean, he mislabeled something. I doubt he knew any better, she added. How disgustingly evil this is. Free Spirit says, her feed's been perfect. Cynthia says, Washington State, USA, where are you? I'm coming to you live from Sydney, Australia. Majed says, woo! Warrior of God says, 99, I'm in Seattle. And Free Spirit says, I'm in far north Queensland, Australia. And Cynthia says, check out Cascadia. They don't want the West Coast getting any information. Maybe I ask too many questions. And Mario says, mislabeled is an opinion. Good point, Mario. Right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 and get these tags, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. According to the FDA, Gerard is also guilty of handing out pamphlets that advertised his product's efficacy in the treatment of a variety of conditions. Because of those claims, the FDA says the products are defined as drugs under the Federal Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act, even though multiple tests have shown no drugs are used in the products. Defined drugs are also required to have their place of production registered with the FDA. Unsurprisingly, the Gerard family and the Gerard farm is not registered, and they likely did not know that salves they were making could be construed as drugs. Another one of Gerard's products, Tamorgan, has also come under fire. The product is said to be very good at removing tumors and also contains bloodroot, which can be caustic and cause scarring. This, the FDA alleges, makes for more than a simple labeling mistake. Along with all of this, the FDA claims that Gerard prevented their agents from entering the family home to inspect the conditions and allege that he continued to sell his products after the injunction was placed. Since 2015, Gerard has fired his appointed attorney and has chosen to represent himself. WKYT reports the Amish farmer filed a motion to dismiss his case, citing a lack of due process, lack of standing, and lack of jurisdiction. A judge denied the motion and set a status conference back in August. Gerard missed the status hearing. Miss O believes that he simply did not understand he had to be there. A warrant was then issued for his arrest. And Compa Blanco 69 is back on duty. Boss, thank you, brother. And Resist the Power said, Joe, a lot of these officials are the pedophiles. Yes. I have a feeling come the next election for the House and Senate will overturn the ones that have held seats for decades. Let's hope we come together and vote them out. I don't know how much using their voting system will work against them unless it's a candidate whose specific goal is to bring down the government, like I will be in the next Australian federal election. And Warrior of God says voting is a joke, and Free Spirit says agreed. Due to the increasingly volatile nature of the situation, the Bath County Sheriff reportedly wrote a letter to the authorities involved, citing his concerns about the ongoing ruthless and relentless attack on one of his constituents. The letter also noted that Gerard had been placed in the protective custody of his office. For about 5 months, Gerard was considered a fugitive and was arrested at the family farm in January. He now waits in jail without bail until his trial date arrives, which is scheduled for late February. The real issue here is the fact that the FDA is persecuting a man with no ill intent. The so-called crimes he committed with no malicious intent and his products have reportedly never harmed anyone. And yet, the FDA approves drugs that don't work and come with horrible side effects as long as they are listed on the label. The agency has even banned intravenous vitamin C, so it's not that surprising that they're throwing the book at Gerard. The extreme punishment being proposed for Gerard is far and away from fitting the crime he committed. Not that you can really call it a crime, a mistake perhaps. His failure to understand the inner workings of the corrupt FDA system does not warrant 68 years of imprisonment. Child rapists go free, while an Amish man will likely spend the rest of his life in prison for making salves. And that is what we're supposed to believe justice looks like. No, no, no. We can see that it is not a justice system. It is a satanic slavery system, and we have to bring the whole stinking system down. That's what we're doing right here, right now. And right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. Warrior of God said, if voting made a difference, they wouldn't let us do it, quoting Einstein. And Shaw says, just wanted to say hi, busy at the moment. Hey Shaw, thank you for tuning in. Revolutionary Warrior number 168. And Faisal says, You're awesome, man. Thank you, brother. Warrior of God says, hi, Liam. Gotta go, brother. Have a good one. Liam, sure. Much love to you. And Paul says, now it's illegal to make soaps and salves. What a joke. It's more than a joke. It's a system designed to kill you and to kill your family. And Warrior of God says, bye, Shaw. And he's going to play some games with friends. Nice one. And Warrior of God says, enjoy. And Mario says, CBD is now Schedule 1 in America. Absolutely ridiculous when these vaccines are legal. Not only are they legal, they're pushing them on the children. And so many children are dropping dead. And Majed said, yes, yes, yes. Resist the Power says, never take your right to vote, that it doesn't count. Yes, there is corruption at the polls, as there have been since our first president in Washington. If you don't vote, you just fell for the bait. Government laid for you to make you think it doesn't count. You know, I disagree with you, Resist the Power. I think it doesn't make much of a difference at all. We have to bring down the entire system instead of choosing one or the other. It is a false dichotomy. But of course, we don't have to agree on everything. No two people agree on everything. And Warrior of God says, ridiculous, put marijuana up there with heroin and cocaine control. It is ridiculous. And Compa Blanco 69 says, we are all family here, revolutionary warriors. Yes, we are. Christian said, Pizzagate, run America. Hi from St. Louis, Missouri. They're not going to run it much longer, my man. We're bringing them down. And Warrior of God shared, thank you. Majed said, I wish we had freedom and no country. Me too, my man. And Sin City Jason says, I want to know who turned him in. I guess he was muscling in on somebody's establishment business. Who knows? It might have been a nosy neighbor. And it's ridiculous we live in such a snitch culture these days where people just want to dob and tattle and snitch on their neighbors and their friends and their family and anyone. They just want to suck up like sycophants with Stockholm syndrome to the government is absolutely sickening. But we will defeat them, my brothers and sisters. And Christian said, I hope so. My brother, rebellions are built on hope. And we will defeat this demonic system. Right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you would like to become Revolutionary Warrior number 468 and get these tags, please put your bid in the comments section. And we can start the bidding at $1. Already, there are more than 495 revolutionary warriors all over the world who have these tags, or whose tags are on the way to them, or whose tags are on my desk ready for me to send to them. And I'm so happy. We're probably going to hit 500 revolutionary warriors today, and I am so happy to have all of you by my side fighting for freedom, saving the world from tyranny. And Christine said, exactly. And Warrior of God says, tobacco and alcohol are worse than marijuana. They are so much worse than marijuana, but the government wants to make weed illegal while tobacco, cigarettes are perfectly legal. Absolutely ridiculous what they are doing. We see through all of their lies and we are here to defeat them. I'm sharing to a bunch of groups now. Thank you very much for sharing this video wherever you can. Once again, share it to your personal page, share it to your friends' pages, share it to any groups that you're a member of. We have to use all of the methods we have to expose what's going on and to defeat this evil system. And Warrior of God says, they are weak and they are soft. I'll tell you what, there's only one word to describe them, and I'm going to spell it out for you. S-O-F-T, soft. Only a few people will get that joke, but thank you for putting up with me. And Christine said, they go so hard to make everything good for you illegal and everything bad is legal and taxed. I hate living in this messed up world. We can't hate being alive. I'll tell you what, it's a beautiful thing to be alive. And I'll tell you what, it's going to be beautiful when we defeat these demons. And Duchess says everything should be decriminalized. We are bringing down the system that is making everything criminal. And Christine said, it's insane. And Warrior of God says, 468, let's go. And Tabasco said, nothing can stop our destiny. We are bringing down these evil systems. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you all for your support. And Rob, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 10, Q-Ball from Brisbane, thank you for tuning in. And Admiral of Truth says we live in a topsy-turvy world. Yes, they want to flip reality on its head. They want to say that boys and girls aren't boys and girls. They are purple penguins. They want to say that up is down. They want to say that left is right. They want to say that 2 + 2 = 5. But we can see what is going on all around us, and we are going to bring them down. And Andy made a stupid comment. I'll tell you what, Andy, if you make another stupid comment, you are going to get booted off of this page and off of this stream. So that was your one warning. And the Duchess says, I want to smoke and drink till I die. That's up to me. Yes, it is, Duchess. And Tabasco says, we are it. Tag, you're it. Yes, we are the ones who are saving the world. And Compa Blanco 69 says, they are softer than cupcakes. That's a nice way of putting it. And Warrior of God says, Chris, I haven't heard that term in a grip. I love it. And Taryn, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 143, Taryn it up. She says, hey, Joe, did you miss me? I missed you. I did. And I'm so glad you are back with us from California. Taryn it up. And Sleepy McCush said, you just made the list. Yes, they did. And Warrior of God said, this is the most exciting time that we could possibly hope to be alive. And that's exactly right. I wouldn't have it any other way. I am so happy to be with all of you courageous, compassionate, caring, revolutionary warriors, because what we're doing right here, right now, is saving the world from tyranny. And Warrior of God says, I love my castaway. Yeah, I'll give that guy one warning. But that's cool. I don't think he's going to make any more stupid comments. If he does, he will make the list of Smokin' Joe. And here we go. You think Trump is a good guy? Oh, Trump is going to save you. Oh, Trump is a good guy. No. White House hints at crackdown on recreational marijuana. So how do you feel about your boy, the Jesuit Illuminati scumbag Cheeto Trump? Now, how do you feel? I told you, this guy is a New World Order Jesuit Illuminati scumbag, and the proof is in the pudding. Right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on this set of tags, please put your bid in the comments section and we can start the bidding at $1. Shamanicist says, Zoltan, ego will be your downfall. Christian says, wake up. And there's no need. Compa Blanco says, screw Donald Trump. Exactly. See how Donald Trump wants to get rid of your weed. From thehill.com by Jordan Fabian from yesterday, or today if you're in the United States, February 23rd, 2017. White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer on Thursday suggested the Trump administration will step up enforcement of federal laws against recreational marijuana. I do believe that you'll see greater enforcement, Spicer said, while adding the exact policy is a question for the Department of Justice. It's the latest sign President Trump is poised to take a tougher approach than the Obama Justice Department did in states that have legalized the use of recreational marijuana. And it goes on and on. They want to make a big crackdown on smoking weed. So that's how much Trump cares about you. Once again, government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem. And Sin City Jason says, I believe that everything and especially the people that they put there for you to choose from, if they are not hand puppets for the Democrats and Republicans, they are not people that we put there. Two-party system is crap. Look at Gary Johnson. They convinced everyone that a vote for him is a vote for Trump or Hillary. Johnson was the only artist candidate on that stage, and they wouldn't let him get close despite having more electoral votes than any other independent or libertarian candidate. I believe that the entire voting system is a joke and our choice is their choice, right or wrong. It's good for them and it's bad for us. I agree with you, Sin City Jason. And Sandrine, who is Super Sandrine, revolutionary warrior number 253. Thank you for tuning in from Sydney. She says hi. And Resist the Power says, Joe, either you have really low ceilings or you're really tall. You just said that Trump, I'm sick physically just hearing his name. I am 6 feet tall, Resist the Power. Probably 6'2" or 6'3" if you include this hair. And Warrior of God says, hi, Sandrine. And Compa Blanco 69 said he wants to get rid of immigrants that are here just to work in the USA. That's pretty messed up. The Duchess says, first time in my life I voted was for Johnson. Won't vote again. And Tearing It Up posted a link. Says, interesting day here. Let me see what you're talking about. Warrior of God says, Johnson? You? And Sandrine says, hi, Lisa. And what is this? Sheriff's office provides cause of death for Eureka transient man whose body was found under a bridge. I wonder what that cause of death was. Drowning and trauma were ruled out. It is crazy what's going on all over the world, and this apparently happened close to you, in Humboldt County, Tearing It Up. It is crazy. And wrong link. And Tearing It Up says 6'5 at least. No, I doubt that. Probably 6'2 with the hair max. And Sin City Jason says autocorrect, not artist honest. And Tearing It Up said wrong link. All right. From landdestroyer.com. Continuity of agenda. Destroying Syria since 1983. I'll put the link to this in the comments section. This is a great article, landdestroyer.blogspot.com. And right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. And I am going to have a drink of fluoride-free water right now. Thank you for sharing this video. And cheers to victory in Operation Bring Down the Government. Oh yeah. February 21, 2017, Tony Cartolucci, aka Neo. Syria's current conflict, beginning in 2011, was the culmination of decades of effort by the United States to subvert and overthrow the government in Damascus. From training leaders of opposition fronts years before spontaneous protests erupted across Syria, to covertly building a multinational mercenary force to both trigger and leverage violence thereafter, the United States engineered, executed, and perpetually violated every aspect of Syria's destructive conflict. And Taryn posted the other link about weed permit applications reveal breadth and location of demand in Humboldt. I bet you there's quite a bit of demand. I might read this later if we have time. Thank you, Taryn. I got it in a new tab here. Adam says, do you have your own filtered water system? If so, what is it called? Yes, I use the ProPure system. I bought that from InfoWars a few years ago. There's the ProPure, there's the Alexa Pure, there's the Big Berkey, there's Reverse Osmosis. Check it out for yourself, do your own research. Right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these tags, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. Enlisting or coercing aid from regional allies, including Saudi Arabia, Qatar, the United Arab Emirates, Turkey, Jordan, and Israel, Syria found itself surrounded at its borders and buried within them by chaos, bringing real muscle to bear against Syria. But recently revealed CIA documents drawn from the US National Archives portrays recent efforts to undermine and overthrow the Syrian government and the Syrian conflict's relationship with neighboring Lebanon and its ally Iran as merely the most recent leg in a decades-long campaign to destabilize and overturn regional governments obstructing U.S. interests. A 1983 document signed by former CIA officer Graham Fuller titled Bringing Real Muscle to Bear Against Syria, and I'll put the link to this PDF in the comments section, this states, Syria at present has a hammerlock on US interests both in Lebanon and in the Gulf through closure of Iraq's pipeline, thereby threatening Iraqi internationalization of the Iran-Iraq war. The US should consider sharply escalating the pressures against Assad Sr. through covertly orchestrating simultaneous military threats against Syria from three border states hostile to Syria, Iraq, Israel, and Turkey. So you can see what's happening today, the people being bombed in Syria today. This goes way back to 1983, even before then. The report also states, if Israel were to increase tensions against Syria simultaneously with an Iraqi initiative, the pressures on Assad would escalate rapidly. A Turkish move would psychologically press him further. The document exposes both then and now the amount of influence the US exerts across the Middle East and North Africa. It also undermines the perceived agency of states including Israel and NATO member Turkey, revealing their subordination to US interests and that actions taken by these states are often done on behalf of Wall Street and Washington rather than on behalf of their own national interests. Jean asks, where are you from? I was born in the ancient city of Cairo in Egypt and I'm coming to you live from Sydney, Australia. And Adam says, I have reverse osmosis, don't know how to spell it, love it. Much better tasting water, if that's possible. Yeah, it's definitely possible. Reverse osmosis is the best system. It gets all of the good stuff, all the bad stuff out, I should say. And for the record, I think, I'm pretty sure that's how to spell it, osmosis. Also mentioned in the document are a variety of manufactured pretexts listed to justify a unilateral military strike on northern Syria by Turkey. The document explains, Turkey had considered undertaking a unilateral military strike against terrorist camps in northern Syria and would not hesitate from using menacing diplomatic language against Syria on these issues. Comparing this signed and dated 1983 US CIA document to more recent US policy papers reveals a very overt continuity of agenda. Decades spanning continuity of agenda, in fact. The corporate financier-funded policy think tank, Brookings Institution, published a 2012 document titled Saving Syria, Options for Regime Change, and I'll put the link to this in the comments section as well, which stated, some voices in Washington and Jerusalem are exploring whether Israel could contribute to coercing Syrian elites to remove Assad. The report continues by explaining, Israel could posture forces on or near the Golan Heights and, in doing so, might divert regime forces from suppressing the opposition. This posture may conjure fears in the Assad regime of a multi-front war, particularly if Turkey is willing to do the same on its border and if the Syrian opposition is being fed a steady diet of arms and training. And we can see that with the government giving billions of dollars to ISIS right now. Such a mobilization could perhaps persuade Syria's military leadership to oust Assad in order to preserve itself. Just as the CIA sought to covertly apply pressure on Syria via Iraq, Israel, and Turkey in 1983, it seeks to do so today. Instead of to simply reopen a pipeline perceived as vital to the Iraqi war effort vis-a-vis Iran in the 1980s, the goal now is regime change altogether. Bear with me for a moment while I have a drink.
Oh yeah.
It should be noted that, in addition to the 1983 CIA documents, U.S. support for violent subversion in Syria during the 1980 through 1988 Iran-Iraq War also included the 1982 Muslim Brotherhood uprising and its subsequent defeat by Syrian forces within Syria, an almost verbatim analogue to the 2011 unrest that led to the current Syrian conflict, also organized and carried out by US-backed elements of the Muslim Brotherhood. It should also be noted that while the 2011 conflict in Syria began under the administration of US President Barack Obama, according to Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist Seymour Hersh's article, the redirection is the administration's new policy benefiting our enemies in the war on terrorism. Planning, training, and staging began at least as early as 2007 under the administration of U.S. President George W. Bush. A concerted, continuous conspiracy to manipulate events across the Middle East and North Africa and project American hegemony throughout the region, spanning now 7 U.S. presidencies, is perhaps the most telling evidence that deeply rooted special interests, a deep state, not America's elected representatives, crafts and executes U.S. policy at home and abroad. And Warrior of God says, wow. And right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you would like to become Revolutionary Warrior number 468 and join our Save the World Army, join Operation Bring Down the Government, and support Operation Bring Down the Government, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. There are more than 495 certified revolutionary warriors all over the world, and Operation Bring Down the Government is only 166 days old. So you can see how much we are growing. We're going to have hundreds. We're going to have thousands. We will have millions and millions of revolutionary warriors who are fighting all over the world. And I thank you all so much for your support. The Pope of Peace, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 103. Thank you very much for tuning in, my brother. He says, woo! Warrior of God says, had we been awakened years ago? Who knows, but we can't go back in time. Well, who knows with the Mandela effect, but we have to make the most of this reality right here, right now. What we do makes a difference right here. And Warrior of God says, hi, Gerald. And Rob Garcia has the high bid now on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 with $1. Thank you very much for that, Rob. If you would like to bid and get your set of tags, please put your bid in the comments section. Once again, Rob Garcia has the high bid with $1. And the Pope of Peace says, hello. It is all about spreading the peace here today. And I'll share to one more conspiracy group before I continue with this article. Thank you all very much for sharing this video. Please share this video wherever you can. Share it to your personal page. Share it to your friends' pages. Share it to any groups that you're a member of. We have to do whatever we can with the tools that we have at our fingertips to expose these demons in the government, because exposing them is the method through which we will defeat them. And I'm sharing to no to constitutional recognition for local councils. Yeah, I'm a member of all these crazy random groups, and what they're good for is sharing all of this revolutionary information. And I thank you all for having the courage to share this video as well. All right, sharing to conspiracy facts, not just all theory. And once again, Rob Garcia has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to get these tags, please put your bid in the comments section, and the high bid is $1. Warrior of God says truth, and Revolutionary Warrior number 8888, Xena, thank you very much for tuning in. So many Revolutionary Warriors here today. Thank you very much. Apples, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 167, who received his tags today. So glad to hear that, my brother Apples. So glad to hear that you got your tags. Much love to you. Warrior of God says, just a general statement. I have always lived in the exact moment. I do my best to live in the moment as well. And I'll share to connoisseurs of truth before I get back to this article. Power is held by unelected special interests, not elected representatives. The notion that the recently elected US President Donald Trump can, is willing to, or is able to suddenly oppose the immense corporate financier interests driving a concerted conspiracy spanning three decades lacks any basis in fact. In reality, those who President Trump surrounded himself with both during his campaign for the presidency and upon assembling his cabinet are among the very conspirators behind this decades-long agenda. For those who find themselves targets of US subversion and aggression, both overt and covert, understanding the deep state and the corporate financier interests that comprise it driving these agendas is essential. Devising a means to expose, isolate, and otherwise disrupt the unwarranted power and influence they wield, rather than dealing with their political proxies in Washington, is the only way to balance the currently lopsided equation of global power. For the American people and citizens of nations beholden to American interests, understanding that change will only come when the corporate financier interests that constitute the deep state are confronted and decentralized, and not through elections involving proxies wholly beholden to the deep state, will be the first step towards taking back national institutions and resources hijacked by these special interests. Great article there. Although I don't agree with everything in there, of course. And Sin City Jason says, Barack Obama, we destroyed all those cities and he created so many angry, displaced, disenfranchised, and now thanks to regime change politics has created all these radicalized Muslim opposition groups. Yes, all by design, of course. And Warrior of God says, hi, Xena. Right now, we're bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on those, please put your bid in the comments section. And Rob Garcia has the high bid with $1. And Warrior of God says, Apples, I love that. I had a German shepherd growing up named Apollo. His nickname was Apples. Nice one. And I'm going to share to one more conspiracy group here before moving on. Thank you once again all for your support. We are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. We have more than 495 Revolutionary Warriors already all over the world. And I reckon we're going to hit 500, if not today, over the weekend. That is so fantastic. And Glendon, thank you very much for tuning in. And the Duchess says, regime change is only okay if America does it. They are looking to regime change the whole world into their one world, new world order government. But we will stop them. We will bring them down, my brothers and sisters. And Warrior of God says, hi, Glendon. And Rob Garcia says, I will be one. Yes, you will, my brother. You have the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 right now. Once again, if you would like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468, please put your bid in the comment section. Ah, now Facebook has me filling in captures to keep moving. That's all right. Now I can concentrate more on reading the articles and reading your comments instead of sharing this video. All right. And Rob Garcia says, I will be one, yes. And Arby says $5. Arby, are you my... Arby, who trains at Gracie Baja St. Peter's Jiu-Jitsu? Arby, is that you? No, that's... It's someone else. My apologies. So Arby has the high bid right now with $5. Thank you very much. And Glendon says, hi, Lisa. And Warrior of God says, Arby, we have a contest. Great. Yes, Arby has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 with $5. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comment section. And my brothers and sisters, oh my goodness. I'm going to have to take a drink of water before I read this article, because here is the latest with the transgender bender agenda. And I've spoken about this before. Beyond transgender madness is trans-abled, where people chop off their arms and legs and pour bleach in their eyes so they can become disabled, because in their heart they're really a disabled individual. And as well as trans-abled, there is trans-species. Yes, trans-species, my brothers and sisters. Warrior of God says, growing fast. And Isaac, who is one of our newest revolutionary warriors from New Zealand, Revolutionary Warrior number 465, Kanna King. Thank you for tuning in, bro, he says. Hello, how are we all today? I'm doing great, bro. And the Duchess says, God, not this again. And Warrior of God says, I'm great, Isaac, yourself. Oh my goodness. Here's this article from naturalnews.com. And you've heard of crazy cat ladies before who have lots of cats. I'll read you this headline, and I'll do my best to read this article without cracking up, because these people have such an insane, I don't know, it's not a mental illness, it's their choice to just be this stupid. Trans species. Woman claims she is actually a cat. February 23, 2017, by Thomas Dishaw. And Zena says, listen to David Wilcock on YouTube. Interesting interviews about the ETs, AI, and the truths they don't want us to know. Yeah, I don't believe too much of what that Wilcock guy says. And Kanna King says, not too bad. I think I have something to trade now. I'll flick you a message after Joe. Nice one, my brother. And Duchess says, she's a furry. Oh, one time when the government took my license away, I was on this bus to a gig in the middle of the country, and I got on the bus and these people were telling me how they went to this furry festival. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. But this is beyond as freaky as furries are. Like, what you want to get down and wear whatever outfits and get freaky, that's cool. Like, do whatever you want, right? But if you want to say you're actually a cat, that's next level. Rob says meow. Tabasco says no. And Arby has posted a cat emoticon. Duchess says lunas, furries, as long as they don't hurt anyone. Yeah, I don't care. They can do whatever they want. And the Duchess says they have Nazi furries. Oh my goodness. Let me get on with this article. But before I do, Arby has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to get a set of these tags, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $5. Mama Spike says LMAO. Alright, here we go. Who didn't see this coming? Nano, a 20-year-old from Oslo, Norway, claims to be trans species and is actually a cat. Much like transgender people, she believes she was born this way and was assigned the wrong species at birth. Nano finally came to terms with the mistake when she was 16 and has lived as a cat ever since. Oh my goodness. I gotta try and read this without laughing. Come on, Joe. In one of her YouTube videos, she claims, "I realized I was a cat when I was 16, when doctors and psychologists found out what was the thing with me. Under my birth, there was a genetic defect." Oh, there's a defect, all right. What qualifies Nano as a cat? Well, oh my goodness. Oh, well. Well, she claims that she naturally hisses at dogs, hates water, and has a superior sense of smell. She can see in the dark and likes to chase mice for fun, although she has not been able to catch any. Keep it up, Nano. One day you'll get there. She speaks mostly in meows, especially to her friend Sven. Sven is not trans species, but claims to have different personalities, one of which is a cat, so he and Nano can communicate when they speak as cats. You can't make this stuff up. And this is illustrating very clearly the madness from people who want to chop off their genitals and say, "Hey, I'm a different gender now." No, you're still the same gender. Oh my goodness, let me see your comments on this madness. And Sleepy McCush says, "Everyone wants to be a cat, haha." And Holly says, "MK Ultra cat persona." You might be right. And Mama Spike says, "Wolf, wolf." And Rob says, "Takes all kinds, my brother." And Resist the Power says, "Joe Furries, grr." And Alex Chino says, "Hey, Joe, what's up? How's your day so far? It's awesome. Thank you very much, Revolutionary Warrior number 83, El Chino 2018. And Cannon King says, "So excited to get my live stream set up, man. Yeah, I can't wait to see it, bro." And the Duchess says, "Lol." And Mama Spike says, "These people are mental." And Sham Anarchist said, "I saw a video of cat lady, bwahaha, she has a cat boyfriend." I think that's Sven here, but he's only a cat some of the time. That's only one of his personalities. Oh my goodness. Resist the Power says, "OMG, a cat, make her purr, lol, ask for a pic of this species." And Cata King is cracking up, and Super Sandrine says, "Does she use kitty litter?" Kitty litter. And yeah, I saw Duchess this, woman who thinks she's a baby. That's not good. And Warrior of God said, "Someone should dress as a skunk and chase her for the rest of her life. That would be so hilarious." Oh, mon ami. Pepe Le Pew reference right there. That's awesome. Sleepy McCush is cracking up. So is Mama Spike. Charmanicist said they took her to Central Station in Amsterdam. Warrior of God says, "Oh no." And Sin City Jason says, "I knew someone that was named Jake. He split his tongue and got his eyes tattooed permanently to look like snake eyes, and subdermal implants on his forehead to make his eyelids look like reptile eyelets. He then asked everyone to call him Snake instead of Jake. Ever since, I lost touch." I think that was a good move, bro. Jake the Snake. Oh my goodness. And this is what happens when people aren't tuned into the truth. They'll attach themselves to any kind of madness to make themselves feel special. Hey, I'm a cat. I'm a donkey. I'm a freaking eagle. Oh my. And as funny as this is, like as hilarious as this is, man, these people are for real. Think of the level of brain damage. Oh my goodness. And Resist the Power says, OMG, stop, I'm laughing so hard I can't breathe. We'll see if it continues. Warrior of God says, oh come on. And Mama Spike says, you can't change your DNA. And Warrior of God says, what in fresh hell? And Glendon says, I saw that, Jason, unreal. And Duchess says, I think you can change your DNA starting with RNA. Yeah, I'm sure all these microwaves coming out of this tablet are changing my DNA right now. And Duchess says, I want to meet Jake. And Isaac said, Jake the Snake, lol. And Warrior of God says, Pepe Le Pew. And Rob Garcia says, SMDH. We need SML. So much love, bro, to get over these idiots. Tabasco said, I just needed to laugh tonight. This is ridiculous. Warrior of God said, you cannot make this up. Ha ha ha. We are bidding right now on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $5. I need to have a drink of water. And excuse me for clearing my throat, but as you can hear, when you clear your throat, obviously you can speak in much more dulcet tones. Thank you very much. And Warrior of God says, I'm a blue-footed booby. Well, you can be whatever you want now. It's the new age, man. You can be whatever. You can be a cat. I'll tell you what, there's no place I would rather be, and there's nobody that I would rather be than myself. Sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a knight in shining armor in a castle by the sea. A knight in shining armor with my princess by my side. I'd start a revolution on my horse that I could ride. And the people would say, Smokin', you're so handsome and so brave. Please rid us of the government who want to make us slaves. So I'd get on my horse and I'd start to ride. I would travel my way through the countryside. I'd come at last to the government's cave and I'd scream at those cowards, we will not be slaves. And the government would be so scared of me that they'd run away. And the people would be free. And the earth is flat. Imagine that. Imagine that. You know, sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a daring, bold explorer sailing far across the sea. I'd set out on a sailing ship to find a distant land. I'd gaze across the ocean with my periscope in hand. And the captain would say, Smokin', there's a big storm drawing near. You're our finest, bravest sailor. You must grab the wheel and steer. So I'd grab the wheel through the wind and rain. I'd steer the ship through the hurricane. I'd guide the ship with a steady hand. I'd lead the way toward a brand new land. I'd spy the land right safe and near. And I'd cry, Land ho! And the crew would cheer. And the earth is flat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Now, sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a revolutionary who looks quite a lot like me, who likes the things that I like and who fights for freedom too. And I don't have to imagine because that's me, Smokin' Joe McHale. That's who. Woo! Sorry to go on that tangent, but thank you very much. Cheers to Operation Bring Down the Limit. Awesome. Sharmika says, here she is, lol lol. And Duchess says, I'm off to the BDSM sites now. Sharmanic has posted a link. Isaac says, I'll bid 650 as a giveaway. Sweet, that can be for a friend of yours, Isaac. So Isaac now has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 with $6.50. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comments section. Tabasco said, "There's no place like home." Aaron said, "Have you served?" "I am serving as the general for Operation Bring Down the Government." "Welcome, Aaron." And Resist the Power says, "Ha ha ha, OMG, still laughing, and she sent it to you?" And is serious. How do we resist this? We got to expose them, and we got to have a laugh. And Canna Warrior says, "The poetry, I love it. Bro, that is from Sesame Street, song by Ernie. I still remember that song. Love that song." Paraphrased, of course. Sin City Jason says, "You know how sick this is? With genetic manipulation, they can create hybrids. Chimeras, yes. They created human-pig hybrids so they could use their organs for transplants. Just think how deep this goes. Yes, it is so incredibly evil." And Warrior of God says, "Hi, Aaron, welcome." And Sleepy McCush posted a link about that dude who changed into a leopard, or got tats, or he didn't change into a leopard, he got tats to look like a leopard. And Kristen said, "Hey, Smokin' Joe, thank you very much for tuning in, Kristen. Kristen is Revolutionary Warrior number 425 minus 5. Thank you for tuning in." And Resist the Power says, "If I'm going to be an animal, I would pick a cooler animal, lol." And Sin City Jason says, "Bert and Ernie, Bring Down the Government remix. That sounds good." And Mama Spike says, "That's really good." And Warrior of God says, "Lol, Patty." Anya asks, "What's in my bottle?" Fluoride-free water. Charmanicus says, "We all need and have dreams. She just went a bit overboard." Warrior of God says, "Lol, at Darren." Glendon says, "What's the bid on the cat woman? I don't want none of that, Glendon." Resist the Power says, "I think my ovaries just fell out from laughing. I'm really glad we can have a laugh, even with these idiots attacking us every day." And Duchess posted a link about the Furred Reich, the truth about Nazi furries and the alt-right. Oh my goodness. Let's continue with this article. Right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior. On Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you would like to get a set of these Bring Down the Government tags and join our Save the World Army and join Operation Bring Down the Government, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $6.50. And Sleepy McCush says, "We need to send Batman after the Catwoman." Ha ha ha. Oh, and Duchess says, "I'm dying." Let me continue. All right. Are we going to have bets? If I can get through the rest of this article without laughing. All right. If I get through the rest of this article without laughing, somebody needs to make a pretty nice bid on the Bring Down the Government tags, but I doubt that I'll do it. All right. Starting now. While it is unclear if this is a hoax or if this young... Sorry. While it is unclear, I got like 10 words. While it is unclear if this is a hoax or if this young lady is sincere, considering the PC climate of late, this could be the next fight we'll hear about. Family Research Council's Peter Sprigg pointed out to LifeSite News, given today's identity politics, I would not be surprised if she is serious. Of course, the temptation is to say, this is obviously ridiculous. You could look at the makeup of her DNA and at the anatomy of her body and know that she is a human being, not a cat. But the exact same thing could be said about a man who claims to be a woman or vice versa. And yet today's political correctness dictates that we treat the latter claim with deadly earnestness. And I'm doing my absolutely best to be earnest while reading this hilarious article. Nano expects people to treat her like a cat, whatever that means. Sure, she likes to be stroked. Oh my goodness. I was about to make a joke there, but I stopped myself. I'm doing Oh, I'll tell you what. The government is poisoning our water every day. They're raping and killing people. But, they do say that laughter is the best medicine. And I'm so glad I can come on here with you revolutionary warriors and have a good old laugh. A real deep belly laugh. You know what I mean? Where you can't stop laughing. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, man. Let me go back to your comments. Anya said, okay, you're cool. You pronounced my name perfect. In my world, that's not common. Yeah, usually if you see a name like that, J is pronounced as a Y for names that kind of look Scandinavian or anything like that. Thank you, Anya. Minus five says, hey Joe, what are you saying about the flat earth? The earth is a flat disk from what I've seen. It's not a ball spinning through space, that's for sure. And I don't want to convince everyone that the Earth is globular or circular or flat or a square or a trapezoid or any other shape. Do your own research, please. Anyone can see from their own research that the Earth is in fact flat. That's why they faked the moon landing to get a fake photoshopped image of this flat Earth. Check out this video on YouTube, 200 proofs that the Earth is not a spinning ball. Check it out for yourselves. And Rob says $7.50. So Rob has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468 with $7.50. If you would like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comment section. The high bid is 750. And Resist the Power says you can't do it, lol. Yeah, you were right. Minus five says lol. Canna Warrior is cracking up. Rob Garcia, yeah, I didn't make it, bro. It was an uphill struggle. Glendon says, Batman, he's strange, wanting to look like a bat, lol. Yeah, I suppose Batman is the first trans species dude. He was pioneering for the trans species movement. Trans species rights. Oh my goodness. And minus five says, I'm Aquaman, drink me. Oh, wow. And Rich says, Merry Christmas, Ed. Why do you keep saying that, Rich? Warrior of God says, doesn't she have 10 teats? Who knows? Purple Haze is cracking up. Rich says, I'm definitely a revolutionary warrior. Yeah, we don't need to be a trans revolutionary warrior. And Resist the Power says, nano stroked. I just got pink eye, OMG. Warrior of God says, drop her 3 stories and see if she still lands on her 4 feet. Glennon says, must be something in your water, lols. And Resist the Power says, lol, Lisa. And Duchess says, be kind to animals, yes. And Isaac has the high bid right now with $8. If you'd like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468, please put your bid in the comment section. Isaac has the high bid right now with $8. Sin City Jason says, so now we need restrooms for men and women and family and one that just states other. No, we're going to need them for trans cats and trans dogs and trans potatoes. Because you can't have a trans potato sharing a toilet with a trans cat, bro. Can't have that. Oh my goodness. And Warrior of God said, we have our disagreements, yes. And Canna King says, trans species toilets 2021. I'm sure they'll be running for that in their. I'm losing it here. I'm sure they'll be bringing that up in their campaign promises in 2020 or 2021. Charmaticus is back. He's cracking up. Purple Haze says, not funny, Isaac. Craig says, ha ha. Why? And Warrior of God says, goes for Robin too. Tweet. Yep. Trans Tweety Birds. We're going to have them as well. And Cynthia says, banned bathrooms. Oh, we might as well do that. And Duchess says, I'll share the toilet with anyone. Oh my goodness. $8 is the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comment section. The high bid's $8. Isaac said, sorry, pulling you off topic, mate. It's all good, bro. It's good to have a laugh. Charmatica said, we'll need more bathrooms, methinks. Yeah, the whole world will just be bathrooms. Everything will be bathrooms. And Warrior of Gods will say yes. And she said, urinals and litter boxes. Yes, you need the litter boxes. All right. Going back to this article. Nano expects people to treat her like a cat, whatever that means. I'm trying to stop laughing. Maybe someone will do us all a favor and pick her up to take her to the pound for euthanization. No, that's nasty. We shouldn't do that. We wouldn't do that to a real cat. Why do that for a trans cat? Nano, of course, is not alone. There are many people out there that firmly believe they are dragons, wolves, dogs, you name it. And they expect to be treated as such by society and demand respect for their movement. Stories like this are the reason why so many of us fight against the transgender movement, which I have dubbed the transgender bender agenda. Feel free to use that one. It is not because we are hateful people, it is to prevent this kind of insanity. These people are suffering from mental disorders and they need serious help. Trying to change the laws to normalize their way of thinking is not the right answer. Whatever people want to do is their prerogative. But when we start putting laws in place that force the majority of the public to suffer, that is a problem. And Glennon says trans species bars just like on Star Wars. Oh, great points, Glendon. And Mama Spike is cracking up. And Duchess says, I'm actually singing the Meow Mix song now. I haven't heard that track. And Warrior of God says, save the restroom. And Minus Five says, Warriors, I am now a remote control. Treat me like a remote, please. Oh, you love getting your buttons pushed, I'm sure. Minus Five, don't we all? And Mama Spike says, come on, Joe, you could do it. No, I can't do it. I'm cracking up all over the place. And Rich asks, how can I be an official on the Revolutionary Warrior number 581? Let me see, Rich. It looks to me like 581 is not taken yet. So, Rich, I'll put you in here if you'd like to be Revolutionary Warrior number. Well, you know what? Rich, you are Revolutionary Warrior number 581. Please send a message with what you would like as your bring down the government code name, 15 characters or less. And Rich, the tags are $20 as the suggested price, or I'm happy to trade or barter. And right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 468, and the high bid is from Isaac with $8. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comment section. Once again, $8 is the bid to beat. And Warrior of God says, throw her outside for the night. And Resist the Power says, I love your laugh, do it more often. Oh no, back to Nano, just let it out. I have a plethora of images running through my head. OMG, OMG, I can't breathe. And Minus Five says, lol, Joe is breaking. It is good to laugh. And Canna King says, where are you, Kristen? I need to change the channel to CNN to get my daily dose of propaganda. And Warrior of God says they had better be careful or the Trumps will hunt and mount them. And Minus Five says, wow, Joe, you got that remote joke. Oh, yeah, you have to get pretty up. I can't even talk now. You have to get up pretty early in the morning to get one past General Smokin' Joe McHale. And Minus Five says, Germany, but I work through Wi-Fi. Awesome. Yes, I sent your tags the other day, Kristen. Let me see exactly when I sent them. I sent them on the 22nd of February, 2 days ago, so they should arrive in Germany very soon. And Rob has the high bid with $10. And Rich says, what are you interested in, Joe? I like books. I love to read. I'm a vegan. I like vegan items. I love prepping items. So something like that, please let me know. From books, I love classic, conspiracy, freedom-minded books. So let me know, Rich. And Kristen said, I would love to barter for 420, but my friend got in way ahead of you and got 420, my brother, Dr. Kenny. So my apologies, that one's already taken, minus five. Admiral of Truth says, I finally got the feedback. It took 5 or 6 refreshes to get it. You can't stop our revolution of love and peace. We will win. Yes, they do their best to stop us from tuning in and to stop us from bringing down their system. And Warrior of God says, maybe cats will help us bring down the government. Yeah, I can't wait to get a trans species revolutionary warrior. And Mama Spike said, oh, Jason, no. And Minus Five said, no worries. And Rob Garcia right now has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you'd like to bid on these, please put your bid in the comments section. And this auction will end in just under 4 minutes. So thank you very much for your support. The high bid is $10. And Canna King says, buying a bunch of old occult books soon. Apparently they're 100 plus years old. Awesome. And Warrior of God says, okay, I'm done with the cat lady. No, sorry, the article's not over yet. And Cynthia says, seriously, the only trans person I know said they did think we had been peeing all this time. Nonsense, he said. Transgender is just the tip of the iceberg. There is a 50-year-old man that identifies as a 6-year-old girl. Oh, have you seen this guy? Oh my goodness, I've got to read this article. Well, I've already read it before. That's even sick. I'm not going to read that now. Look it up for yourselves. I'll put this article in the comment section. This big, fat, 50-year-old dude thinks he, is saying he's a 6-year-old girl and he's hopping around. My name is Lala. What? Oh. Absolute insanity. Absolute insanity. Oh my God. And Duchess says, trans people have been peeing next to you forever. Yeah, there is a 50-year-old man that identifies as a 6-year-old girl and even got adopted by a family. There are people who want to amputate healthy limbs because of their image of themselves as an amputee. Yes, they are those trans-abled idiots I was talking about before. I guess if I rob a bank, I'll just claim to be trans-rich and should be exempt from punishment since I was born that way. Conservatives and libertarians need to continue to lobby our lawmakers, blah blah. I'm not going to lobby lawmakers. We need to just expose this absolute nonsense. Duchess says, that's the one I was looking for. Crazy. And Admiral of Truth said, this is ridiculously sick. Yes, it is. Mama Spike's cracking up. Duchess says, firing squad. Warrior of God says, these are brain issues. Yes, they are. 1 minute and 20 seconds to go in the auction to become Revolutionary Warrior number 468. If you would like to become Revolutionary Warrior number 468, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $10 and there is 1 minute and 5 seconds to go. Charmanica said, we will need a sand pit in the bathroom. Nice one. And here we go. People talking about this Milo Yiannopoulos guy. You know, this Milo Yiannopoulos guy has spoken and he has advocated having sex with children or molesting children in the past. Here we go. From landdestroyer.blogspot.com.au. How Breitbart got conservatives to forget morality and embrace pedophilia. February 23, 2017 by Tony Cartolucci. 30 seconds to go. There are 30 seconds to go in the auction for Revolutionary Warrior number 468 and the high bid is $10. 15 seconds to go. Rob Garcia has the high bid with $10. 10 seconds to go, and we're going to count it down for number 468. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner. Congratulations to Rob Garcia from the Mile High City, Denver, Colorado, who is now revolutionary warrior number 468. Thank you very much. Congratulations to you, Rob Garcia. Please send me a message and let me know what you would like as your Bring Down the Government code name, 15 characters or less for your code name. Thank you very much. And our army continues to grow. If you would like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. We can start the bidding at $1. And right now, Christian, we're bidding on number 469. And Rich said, cool Joe, but 581, gonna get it for the revolution always. All right, Rich, I already put you down as 581. That's yours, brother. And Warrior of God said they need some of that big, yummy pharma antidote. And Rob says that would be me. Congratulations, bro. King Kevin says, sorry, General Joe, tuning in late. Been dancing with Mary Jane. She left me feeling so fine. Nice one, my brother. Glad you're here, Revolutionary Warrior number 340. And Canna King says, congratulations, Rob. Admiral of Truth says, welcome, Rob. And Warrior of God says, Rob, woo! And Rob says, thank you, sir. And Christian, yes, the auction for 469 is live now. We can start the bidding at $1. Mama Spike is giving Rob a round of applause. Charmanicus posted a link. Oxygen levels in the ocean have dropped due to climate change. We know that climate change is a false, fake, fraud, a facade. And Admiral of Truth now has the high bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 469 with $5. Thank you, bro. If you'd like to bid on number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. High bid is $5. Nimenberg, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 393. Thank you for tuning in, my brother. I sent your tags on the 17th, and they're still coming in from Canada, so you'll probably get your tags next week. Thank you for tuning in, Nimenberg. And Warrior of God says 469. And Christian said, on average, how much per tag? I don't know. I would say definitely less than 10 per average. If you count away all the tags that I'm giving away for free, if you count them, it's probably like $2 or $3 per tag that I cover the rest. And Sin City Jason says, ding, ding, winner, winner, tofu chicken dinner. I like that. And Warrior of God says, hi, Stephen. And Warrior of God says, Lola, Jason. And Nimen Burr says, hey, Lisa, hope you're good. And Isaac has the high bid with $6.50. Thank you very much, Isaac. And Lisa said, yes, you. And Nimen Burr says, always good, thanks. Nice to hear. And Chris Bird said, number 469 is pretty sweet. You know it, my brother. Every single number is sweet because we are the army that is saving the world. If you would like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. And the high bid is $6.50. Canna King says, how could an earth that provides for so plenty be hurt by things as small as us? The earth survived long before us, and it will survive long after us. It's these demons who are poisoning every aspect of our environment. We are here to bring them down. Here we go. How Breitbart got conservatives to forget morality and embrace pedophilia. Breitbart News is what many on the right side of America's controlled political paradigm consider real news versus liberal media's fake news. However, in reality, Breitbart is a textbook case of what is called cognitive infiltration. It is the establishment's attempt to reassert itself, its narratives, influence, and agenda amid an information space increasingly decentralized and controlled by genuine alternative media. In order to do this, Breitbart poses as an alternative media outlet itself, taking on a conservative identity to draw in many on the right of American politics. Cognitive infiltrators also target left-leaning Americans, and it has worked masterfully. It is an amazing feat by the establishment to have first, under the administration of US President Barack Obama, gotten liberals to embrace endless wars of aggression, and now to convince conservatives to defend advocates of child rape and the act of child rape itself. The basic facts of what Breitbart really is versus what it claims to be expose this clearly. While it poses as anti-establishment alternative media, it peddles wars and other aspects of the establishment's agenda. It is also working diligently to divide and distract their audience, pitting them against one another, rather than exposing and targeting the special interests who dominate over them all. Charmanica says, already read that. Edward says, I love sitting around the chestnut tree, smoking my hookah, blowing heart-shaped clouds, while listening to Lynyrd Skynyrd in my twisted sister under britches. Some say it's weird, but it's what I do to relax after work. My problem is my neighbor keeps bothering me by taking pictures of myself over the fence. Is this invasion of privacy, and what can be done about this? P.S. My friend tells me to build a taller fence. However, that's not an option. Any suggestions? I would say, talk to your neighbor and say, stop taking pictures of me. Christian said, 1773 for free for a broke brother. I'll tell you what, Christian Castillo, you want a set of tags and you're broke? That's cool. I know what it's like to be broke, my man. Send me something in exchange as a trade. Christian Castillo, if you have something cool that you can trade me, like a book or whatever, hit me up. Send it to me, and I will give you 1773, because it's all about the love here. And you know what, Christian Castillo, I'll put you in the spreadsheet right now as 1773. Somebody already has 1776, that is Wawa. And Christian Castillo, you are now Revolutionary Warrior number 1773. So hit me up, Christian, send me a message. Let me know what you would like to trade my brother. And Duchess says, we can kill the earth pretty easily. And Christian said, Monsanto is killing us. You are right, my brother. And Canna King says, I feel like we could cause a lot of bad damage, maybe even make it so humans can't survive, but we can't fully destroy it through our pollution, etc. In my belief, it would blossom back to life eventually if we destroyed it. Mother Nature always finds a way. Yeah, but they're doing their best to poison every aspect with Fukushima, with the chemtrails, with the fluoride, with the GMOs taking over all these crops. It is so sickening. And Canna King says, about to smoke a lovely fat bong to the revolution. Bro, pack that one up high to the sky and smoke it for your brother, General Smoking Joe McHale. Thank you. And Admiral of Truth says, welcome, Christian. Yes, welcome. Thank you very much. And Edward says, thanks, Joe. I will try talking to her. Thanks for the advice, my friend. Sounds like she's a bit keen on you, Edward Williams. And Warrior of God says, woo! Woo indeed. Right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 469. If you would like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $6.50. Continuing with this article, Agents of Division and Conquest, and this is for all you Milo fans. Enter Milo Yiannopoulos, who just recently resigned as a Breitbart News senior editor. He was an obvious provocateur, aiming clearly at dividing and distracting Americans from real issues. He made provocative comments targeting various groups in his and Breitbart's efforts to further polarize the American people and lend greater leverage and control to the corporate financier interests that truly dominate American politics. In his bid to further polarize the American people between left and right, he characterized the left as condoning and defending pedophilia. In a 2016 article written by Yiannopoulos and published by Breitbart titled, Here's Why the Progressive Left Keeps Sticking Up for Pedophiles, he argues, today, Salon gave a platform to a self-confessed pedophile to explain his urges in sympathetic terms. "I'm a pedophile but not a monster" reads the headline. It's a long, self-pitying screed that ends with a call to be understanding and supportive of adults who crave sexual intimacy with children. Forgive me if I'm not first to start the standing ovation. In fact, I'm pretty shocked. I'm pretty sure most people will find the existence on Salon's website of this post both shocking and distasteful. Yiannopoulos continues by saying, "Progressives who got fired up about whether green and purple was a rapey color scheme were suddenly fine with discussion of incestuous pedophilia from a 22-year-old in a chat room full of teenagers. It has been a somewhat grotesque spectacle to watch." He continues by claiming, "Radical leftists may be planning to make pedophilia another front in their civil rights battles, but it won't happen without a fight, nor should it." In the minds of many reading Breitbart News, they envision the American left as advocates of predators who seek to sexually abuse their children. And in many cases, the establishment left are just that. But, as it turns out, so is the establishment right. Yiannopoulos himself advocated sex with children. And I'll get into this quote after reading your comments. Oh, not many comments here. Dan, thank you for sharing this video, my old DJ buddy, Dan Bascariol, and Warrior of God says woo. And share this video while I have a drink. Thank you very much. Cheers to victory in Operation Bring Down the Government. And right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 469. If you'd like to bid on these and get your own set of Bring Down the Government tags, please put your bid in the comment section. The high bid is $650. Yiannopoulos himself advocated sex with children. Clearly, the act Yiannopoulos put on during his role at Breitbart, his role as agitator at Breitbart, diverges significantly from who he really is and what he really stands for. In an interview with Yiannopoulos on the Drunken Peasants podcast posted on January 4, 2016, he unequivocally defends grown men having sex with children as young as 13 and claims that pedophilia is only a sexual attraction to a child who has not reached puberty yet. However, regardless of Yiannopoulos' opinion on the matter, adults having sex with a 13-year-old child is most certainly pedophilia. Back to your comments. Rich asks, "Are all GMO foods bad for you and what can I do? They're too much for me. What can I do?" This is 581 Smoking Joe. Grow your own food as much as you can. Eat organic as much as you can. Get on a raw diet. Get on a vegan diet. I've been vegan since 2015 and I'm going on a raw diet as of March 1. I'm taking the Bring Down the Government March 2 Victory Raw Vegan Challenge. Canna King says, "Honestly disgusting." And Revolutionary Warrior 10 Thier, number 391. Thank you for tuning in. He says, "If people only do not divide, that will bring them down." Yes. Warrior of God says, "Climate change along with poisonous gases and substances bombarding our habitat will eventually cause our demise. Either way, it would be self-destruction. Ain't gonna be no demise on my watch." And King Kevin says, "Lots of sick people in this world, General Joe." Yes. Warrior of God says, "Disgusting." Cynthia says, "The baiting and fake news in America right now is insane. All kinds of people are going insane." Yes. And Warrior of God says they can burn. Continuing. Clearly, the real Yiannopoulos has nothing to do with the values many who call themselves conservatives or right of the American political spectrum identify with. Clearly, upon watching Yiannopoulos' full interview, no conservative or right-wing American could support or agree with Yiannopoulos or find him anything less than precisely what they allegedly stand against. Yet, here is where the system's cognitive infiltration has worked so masterfully. Because of the media circus on both the left and right of American politics surrounding Yiannopoulos and his provocations preceding these revelations and the amount of investment those on the right put into defending him, they are incapable of now divesting, even as their hero is revealed as absolutely everything they stand against. The guy promotes pedophilia. And if you promote pedophilia, in my eyes, you are a putrid, procrustean, pusillanimous, pernicious, pathetic, pencil-necked pedophile. In many cases, hardcore conservatives can now be seen attempting to downplay Yiannopoulos' comments, accusing others of taking his comments out of context, despite them being easily accessed in the above full video of the interview, or even attempting to downplay the significance of adults consorting sexually with 13-year-olds. It is an amazing feat by the establishment to have first, under the administration of Obama, gotten liberals to embrace endless wars of aggression, and now to convince conservatives to defend advocates of child rape and the act of child rape itself. What cognitive infiltration is accomplishing is not only the reasserting of the establishment's agenda over genuine alternative media, but also a consolidation and unification of that agenda under alternative left and right cover. Glendon says, can I look you up, Lisa? Charmanicus says, no live chat. Warrior of God says, you may. Good, Darren. Awesome. Right now, we're bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 469. If you would like to support Operation Bring Down the Government and join our army of peaceful revolutionary warriors, please put your bid in the comments section. If you'd like to be number 469, the high bid is $6.50. Kenna King says, really need to stop eating meat, especially non-organic stuff. It's so bad for us. Yeah, bro, take the Bring Down the Government March to Victory Raw Vegan Challenge. No, nothing that's not raw vegan in the month of March. And Dutch just posted a link about some kind of gender stuff. I don't even know if I want to get into that right now. So much more news to get to today. There is a lot more to read. I'm going to have another drink. Thank you for your support. Cheers to victory. Can someone give me a timestamp, please? How long have we been broadcasting for today? Please let me know. What Breitbart was, is, and always will be. What, is Bret Hart working for Breitbart now? Sorry. Yiannopoulos is nothing more than a hired agitator, an actor who is using politically conservative memes to psychologically manipulate a segment of the population while his colleagues elsewhere target and manipulate liberals. He has no real affinity for conservative values, no more so than those who do peddle absurd social justice agendas. And 2 hours 35, thank you very much, guys. He has piecemeal revealed his true values or lack thereof in various interviews, advocating everything from decriminalizing sexual assault against women to child rape. Breitbart itself has been under the control of Steve Bannon, a former Goldman Sachs banker and now a member of US President Donald Trump's administration, alongside other Goldman Sachs alumni, collaborators of convicted financial criminal George Soros, and representatives of America's immense arms industry. Breitbart, too, has no real affinity for conservative values and only uses them as a vector to gain trust and reassert establishment influence over segments of the population being lured away by genuine alternative media. What is most ironic about the rise and current influence of Breitbart News and its so far crowning achievement in convincing conservatives to defend an advocate of child rape is that its function as a cognitive infiltrator was laid out by a decidedly liberal villain, Cass Sunstein, under the Obama administration. And right now we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior Number 469. If you'd like to bid on this set of Bring Down the Government tags, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $6.50. And Dubsy said, love your work, mate. Keep it up. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Your support is what keeps me going to do this for hours every day because honestly, guys, the government's murdering people. They're raping children. They're pushing this child rape everywhere. They're enslaving the human race. We've got to do whatever we can to bring them down. And I will never give up. I will never give in. I will never stop until we defeat them. Thank you for your support. Once again, if you'd like to bid on Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $6.50. Thank you for your support. Kelly says, I'm Cynthia's husband. She had me watch you for a moment and I fell in love. Right on, brother. Much love to you, Kelly. And Warrior of God says, hi, Kelly. In Sunstein's 2008 paper titled Conspiracy Theories, he stated explicitly that governments can partially circumvent these problems if it enlists non-governmental officials in the effort to rebut the theories. It might ensure that credible independent experts offer the rebuttal rather than government officials themselves. There is a trade-off between credibility and control, however. The price of credibility is that government cannot be seen to control the independent experts. Although governments can supply these independent experts with information and perhaps prod them into action from behind the scenes, too close a connection will prove self-defeating if it is exposed, as witness the humiliating disclosures showing that apparently independent opinions on scientific and regulatory questions were in fact paid for by think tanks with ties to the Bush administration. Even apart from this trade-off, conspiracy theorists may still fold independent third-party rebuttals into their theory by making conspiratorial claims of connection between the third party and the government. What is Breitbart News and agitators like Yiannopoulos, if not faux independent, third parties advocating government policies and agendas? How exactly is Breitbart News truly independent or anti-establishment when it peddles the establishment wars, intentionally divides people against one another, making them easier for the establishment to control and manipulate, and attempts, as Yiannopoulos has successfully done, to lure conservatives into hitherto unacceptable ideological territory such as defending child rape? Oh. So crazy. And William, I saw you here yesterday, William. Thank you for tuning in, my brother. Rich says, hey, Smokin' Joe, it's 581 Warrior. How can I get into being an admin in the Revolutionary Warrior movement? You need a squad of 10 if you want to be promoted to sergeant. What can I do more than I do now, because now I'm in and I want to change all around for the better of mankind? Nice one, Rich. You want to be promoted? Get a squad of 10, but don't get ahead of yourself, my brother. I still need your code name, Revolutionary Warrior number 581. Thank you for your support, everybody. Warrior of God says, hi, William. She says, love, Rich. And Mitchell says, sounds like Australia more than America. Free Spirit says, I'm actually the result of child rape. My mother was 8 when it started, and she had me at 15. It was her stepfather. Never met him, never wanted to. Absolutely infuriates me, because this ruins so many lives. It's funny how this abuse gets passed down generations, but I'll tell you one thing. No one got near my kids. I changed it, and made damn sure it didn't happen to them. I've always been a fighter, which is why I'm here. All I could do was gain strength from those experiences and carry on. I love being a warrior, always have. Much love to you, Free Spirit. We are working to bring down all of these scumbags who are abusing children all over the world, and we will defeat them. King Kevin says, yes, but we will still appreciate you, General Joe, but we need you as well. to take your time out of your busy schedule. That makes you a very special person. That's why we all love you. I love you, King Kevin. Admiral of Truth says, break the cycle. Good for you. Sending love. Yes, sending love to you, free spirit. And Rich says, thanks, Joe. Warrior of God says, please help me, General Joe, come to the US, all 50 states, and help out on the GoFundMe page. Yes, Warrior of God, thank you so much for your donation and for starting this GoFundMe page to get me to the United States. I'll post the link right here. Thank you very much. I'm supposed to be there right now. Flights didn't come through. So you revolutionary warriors, thank you so much for getting me there. Tabasco said, Sherry, you are a true hero. I had to destroy a lot of abuse as well. Sharon, Shamanica said, break the cycle. Warrior of God says, love, Cherie. Cherie says, love. Warrior of God says, proud of you. And Tabasco says, Cherie, so much love. Yes, it's all about the love here. Right now, we are bidding on Revolutionary Warrior number 469. If you'd like to bid on these, please put the bid in the comment section. The high bid is 650. Tabasco said, Cherie, so much love. Yeah. Fake news is easy to identify. It exists in the establishment right and left and among the alternative right and left. If it is news aimed at advocating or getting support for the government and the special interests that dominate it, or seeks to divide people against each other rather than focusing on uniting people against abusive special interests, it is fake news. Breitbart is most certainly fake news. Its counterparts on the left are fake as well. Together, like the lineup at a professional wrestling event, they put on a show with an adversarial narrative. This is a great analogy. Behind the scenes, they are all working together, a single organizer, profiting from emotions they provoke from the crowds that keep them coming back for more. As long as suspension of disbelief can be maintained, the organizer continues to profit. For Americans to believe that after decades of a singular, continuous agenda dominated by special interests, a president surrounded by bankers, warmongers, and supported by pedophiles is going to suddenly shift the paradigm is likely a fatal delusion that will only accelerate and expand this current decidedly unacceptable paradigm. For conservatives now finding themselves rushing to the defense of a child rape advocate, they need to take serious stock in what they are doing and why. Is defending a man who advocates sex with 13-year-old boys going to make America great again, or simply and only temporarily protect their delicate egos and pride? Thank you all so much for your support. Man, they're murdering these children every day. They're raping these children every single day. I am sick of it. I've had enough of it. That's why I dedicate my life to bringing down this stinking government. And I thank you all so much for your courage and your support. This auction is going to end real soon. If you'd like to become Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comments section. The high bid is $6.50. And Free Spirit says, being part of this is very healing. I love it. Thank you so much, Joe. And honestly, Free Spirit, that really, like, I'm doing my best. But to hear you say that after what you just said, that really means a lot to me. And I really appreciate that so much. Thank you for your support. And I'm glad I can do my best to help as many people as I can. If you would like to bid on this auction for Revolutionary Warrior number 469, please put your bid in the comment section. This auction will end in 3 minutes. It'll end in 3 minutes, and the high bid is $6.50. I want you all to know that there's a hero. If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. My brothers and sisters, this is no joke, this is no movie, this is no game, this is your life and it's ending 1 second at a time. Governments all over the world are poisoning, assaulting, murdering, raping, and enslaving innocent people. It's up to you to be the hero to beat the Illuminati, break the New World Order, and bring down the government. And Kelly bids $10. Thank you very much. Looking to join his wife in becoming a revolutionary warrior. And Chris said the song One Day. Yes, by Mattis Yahoo. One day I lay under the moon and thank God I'm breathing. And I pray don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it will all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will play. One day, one day, one day, that day will soon be upon us, my brothers and sisters. Kelly has the high bid with $6. Excuse me, with $10, and there are 50 seconds to go, 45 seconds to go in the auction for Revolutionary Warrior number 469. If you'd like to bid on that, please put your bid in the comments section. 40 seconds to go, $10 is the high bid. Canna King says, Joe helped me realize that I need to spread awareness, plant seeds, open the eyes of the sleeping. It's our job to save humanity. Yes, it is. We are the heroes right here. Free Spirit says, yes. Warrior of God says, Kelly. And Canon King says, woo, Kelly, let's get it, man. There are 15 seconds to go in the auction for Revolutionary Warrior 469, and Kelly has the high bid with $10. All right, less than 10 seconds to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner. Congratulations to you, Kelly Thompson, who is Revolutionary Warrior number 469. I'm putting you in the spreadsheet right here. Thank you very much, Kelly. Congratulations, you are the latest Revolutionary Warrior. Thank you for your support. Please send me a message with what you and your wife would like for your code names. And Cannon King says, woo, Kelly, let's get it, man. And he says, welcome, Kelly, my brother. Thank you all so much for your support. Have a great weekend. I'll be back on Monday. Same Bring Down the Government time. Same Bring Down the Government channel. If you would like to support me getting to the United States, here's the link to the GoFundMe that Warrior of God started. Admiral of Truth says, welcome, Kelly. How many total warriors now? It's pretty much knocking on 500, my man. I'll do a count after this. And Rob says, welcome, 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 welcome to you, Rob. Everybody who won tags today, please send me messages now with what you would like your code names to be, 15 characters or less. I might not get back to you for a while because I'm going to have a late lunch. It's 5:43 p.m. here, and I'm going to partake in some Mary Jane before electrifying this evening. So thank you very much for your support. I am Revolutionary Warrior number one, General Smoking Joe McHale. Here's the link to the GoFundMe page if you want to help me go to the United States. Like I'm saying, I'm Revolutionary Warrior number one, General Smoking Joe McHale, and together we will beat the Illuminati, break the New World Order, and bring down the government. I love each and every single one of you. I'm telling you, we have the power that will save the world. I have the power. You have the power. We have the power. Humanity has the power, and we have to use that power to beat the Illuminati, break the New World Order, and bring down the government. I love you all, and I will see you next time. Have a great weekend. The revolution is here, and we will be victorious. Woo! Yeah.